Well, it's the final that nobody expected. Newry City against Portadown going head-to-head here at Mournview Park for this, the Cooperative Insurance Cup. Kickoff is less than half an hour away. Before that, we've plenty to whet the appetite. Our big match build-up starts with a look back at the two semi-finals. We'll also hear from the two managers, Newry's Gerry Flynn and Ronnie McFall of Portadown. We'll get the thoughts of former Northern Ireland international Tommy Wright, and we'll bring you a full roundup of last night's action from the JJB Sports Premiership. That's coming up shortly. And joining me here in the studio, two of our best known managers, Linfield's David Jeffrey and Crusaders' Stephen Baxter. Good to have you both with us this afternoon. But first, here's how today's two teams made it to the final.
Portadown have reached today's final the hard way. Having seen off Cliftonville and Linfield, they then came from behind in the semi-final against Glentoran. Wesley Boyle's effort ensured that there would be extra time required at Windsor Park, where substitute Richard Leckie eventually pilfered the winner. As for Newry, well, they're familiar with Mournview Park, where they too came from behind to win the other semi-final. A double strike from former Linfield player Stephen Garrett brought that game into extra time. And then City skipper Richard Clark steered his side into today's final. Now, here is the confusing bit. That's Richard Clark on the right, and that's also Richard Clark on the left. The cousins were due to go head-to-head today, but injury has since left Richard Clark in red snookered.
So only Newry's Richard Clark on show today, but Portadown's injured Richard Clark, he's still here as well, and he's live pitch side with Mark.
Thank you very much, Stephen. He's a little nervous at the moment, right in the middle of the Newry squad. Richard, first, profoundly disappointing, late fitness test this morning, and you failed.
Yeah, obviously I'm gutted, you know, gut wrenched when I heard I wasn't able to make the squad, you know, so very disappointing for myself personally, but it doesn't change things for the team, you know. It's still a good day out for the squad and a trophy there for us.
I know one of the first people you bumped into this morning was your cousin, Richard. What's the other Clark been saying to you? Obviously commiserating.
I obviously told me he was gutted for me as well, like, and disappointed. So I just told him to get on with the game, you know, and enjoy himself, because cup finals go quickly, you know, and told him the best of luck. But obviously I'm hoping he doesn't win.
You've been on such a good run of late too. Presumably you will expect that run, Richard, to continue today.
Well, it's the same when it comes into a cup final. Sort of everything that happens before goes out the window, and it's on the day who's up for the match, you know. But I think we've got a quality in the squad to go on and win the game, definitely.
Are you expecting it to be a high-scoring affair?
I think so. I think both teams will go for it, and the type of match both teams will fancy their chances, you know. But I think there could be a few goals in the game, and hopefully more for us than them.
We appreciate you joining us very much, Richard. Stephen, by the way, he tells me that he's the only major injury concern in that squad. I have spoken to one of the Newry mentors, and he tells me that Lee Feeney's undergone a late fitness test. Watch out for him, it's a calf problem. Chris Morgan, they've said, go at it for the first 20, but if it's a tweak at all in that groin, let us know immediately and you will be off. So watch out for both Lee Feeney and Chris Morgan.
Well, we'll take a look at those team lineups in just a moment. First, David, Stephen, it's hard to pick a favourite today, isn't it?
Very hard to pick, Stephen, because a lot of people have been saying that, you know, Portadown are favourites because they are a Premiership team, all in their status because of a clerical error last year. But I've got to agree with Ronnie McFall on this, because they're playing at a, with respect, a lower standard of football. Newry are playing in the Premiership every week, so the game's quicker and faster. In saying that, I'm almost going to be contrary, because Portadown gave us a footballing lesson on two occasions and did fantastically well. And in Ronnie McFall, I feel they have the most outstanding manager there's ever been in Irish League football.
Portadown with a point to prove because they're playing in the Championship, but Newry also haven't won a trophy for over 20 years, so they've both got something to prove today.
Well, it's going to be a big day out for Newry. It's going to be a little test of their character, because I think Ronnie McFall's team will be right up for it today. I think they're going to have a big point to prove, so they'll come at it right from the first whistle. But Gerry's a knowledgeable guy, he knows his tactics well. He'll get a good shape in behind the ball, and then he'll try and hit them on the counter-attack with young Garrett over the top. Great pace, great ability. And he's the match winner, I think, in the semi-final, so they'll have to watch him very closely today.
Let's take a look at that Portadown lineup this afternoon. David, for people who are perhaps tuning in to see some live Irish League action today, who haven't watched a lot of it before, pick out a few names for us to look out for there today.
Well, the outstanding one for me is John Convery. a quality centre-back, you know, who has been plagued by injury, but a superb player. Andrew Hunter, who we had at Linfield, who Stephen had at Crusaders, and has come down to Portadown, absolutely fantastic. But one I think you've really got to watch is Wesley Boyle. On his day, he's as good as anything that there is in the league. He was dynamite against us down at Shamrock Park, and if Wesley's on his game today, then Newry, watch out.
Stephen, do the same with the Newry team for us. Obviously a big boost with Chris Morgan and Lee Feeney coming through fitness tests for Gerry Flynn.
Yeah, I think in Stephen Ferguson and Richard Clark in the centre of midfield today, they're going to be the heartbeat of the Newry team. And if they're going to get something out of the game, they're going to have to play at the top of their game. And I think in Richard Clark, we're probably one of the most outstanding performers in Irish football. So they'll need to watch him closely. So it's going to be a big test in the centre of midfield today. But those are the two players for me who will open up this Portadown back four.
OK, thank you for the moment. The men in charge of today's team certainly have differing levels of managerial experience. Here's Mark again.
He's been there, done it. He's got the T-shirt. He must be delighted with the way his team played today.
Standing side by side, but they are two men at polar opposites of their managerial careers. Ronnie McFall, almost three decades in the job and chasing his 30th trophy as a manager. Gerry Flynn, in search of his first.
You know, Ronnie's record's there. It's a fantastic record. He's done it over a number of 20 years. And, you know, it is my first final. But as I say, if we can produce the performance that I know the boys are capable of, then, you know, we're confident we're going to bring the cup back to Newry.
Well, my experience is you just enjoy the day. We'll just prepare as best we can, as we normally do, and make sure that the players are fully focused. At the end of the day, it's all about the players performing on the day.
Irish Cup winners as recently as 2005, and having already accounted for Cliftonville, Linfield and Glentoran in this competition, Ronnie McFall is keen to acquire another Premier League scalp.
It's a motivation for us. I said the players have been excellent all season, you know, the league that we're in at the minute. And certainly when we played the Premier League teams, we've really been up for it. And they've got a point to prove. And so far they've done that.
They weren't put out for anything other than a mistake by, you know, an official at the club getting the application in late. But, you know, their focus is, you know, on proving people wrong. Ours is slightly different. Ours is all about winning the cup. And, you know, that's what we intend to do.
Well, one man who knows both managers very well is former Northern Ireland international goalkeeper Tommy Wright, also a former manager of Ballymena. He's live pitch side with Mark.
Thank you very much, Stephen. Tommy, let's just start you there with both of today's managers. Obviously, Ronnie McFall, vastly experienced. Can you see Gerry somehow get one over on him?
Well, obviously, Gerry's going for his first trophy. Ronnie's going for his 30th trophy. They're obviously, the experience is all with Ronnie. He's been through this many, many times. Gerry's really, once the game started, it's all down to his players. He'll have prepared them well. And, you know, it's a great opportunity for him to get his first trophy. Will he get it? You know, I don't really know, because I think the game is really close to call.
Both squads obviously vastly experienced. Any danger when you look to Newry, 6-7 of those guys haven't played in a cup final before, that they could freeze on the day?
Yes, there always is that possibility. But I think, you know, again, preparation will be vital to them. And Gerry will have probably, you know, had them pretty relaxed this week. And try and emphasise it's a day to go out and enjoy it. You know, cup finals are there to be enjoyed. And obviously, you know, he's got a young squad, but I think he's got quality in the squad, which will show in the game today.
The taking off and the playing of the game here in Moorview Park, Tommy, we're standing on the pitch, and you have to say the stadium, it's compact, it's in on you. It seems that it's perfect, the pitch too, in great condition.
Absolutely great decision by the powers that be. I know they get a bit of stick at times, but they've made the right decision. You know, the ground's looking magnificent, it's nice and compact, there's a great atmosphere. And, you know, with all due respect, you know, these two clubs weren't going to, you know, make a fill Windsor Park, so it's a right decision to bring it to Moorview.
Final brief question. You're now at Shamrock Park with Michael Hughes. You could well have been here, but a couple of weeks ago we were told you were on your way. What happened?
Jackie Fullerton basically put a spanner in the works for me. No, I didn't, Mark. You know, things happen in football. The timing just wasn't right. You know, a week later, I possibly could have been here. And this would have been a great club to manage. But I'm not. I'm down with Michael at Shamrock Rovers, and I'm looking forward to that role. And, you know, I'm just waiting. Marty Quinn, I think, has got a brown envelope for me, which I'll pick up later on.
Wish you well at Shamrock Rovers. Back up to you, Stephen.
It really is the experienced manager today, Ronnie McFall, against the young pretender, isn't it?
Very much so, Stephen. Roy Coyle is rightly much lauded. But when you look at Ronnie, he took Porto down when they were most unfashionable. And what he has done and what he's achieved there, I think, deserves great, great credit. Very, very dynamic man in his own way. People wouldn't think that. They think he's very, very dour. But with his players, they love him to bits. And he's a Porto down man through and through.
As you saw in the quarter-final, as we take a look at the goals there.
Well, you know, as I say, they beat us and beat us well. Here is a phenomenal strike by Wesley Boyle. I think Stuart Allison needed another 3 or 4 inches. Here's another great strike. Great football. Cut us wide open. And look at that. And on the evening, Porto down were the better side. And in fact, Stephen, on that night, they could have maybe beaten us 5 or 6. Here's another effort again. You know, we were left wanting, and we had no complaints. Porto Down were by far the better side on both occasions, and they are deserved winners and deserving to be here in the final today.
Yeah, Ronnie McFall, 4 Irish leagues, 4 Irish Cups at Shamrock Park, but he says if he wins this today, it'll be one of his greatest managerial achievements, trying to hype it up a bit because his team's playing in the Championship. A few mind games creeping in there, I think.
I think Ronnie feels the world's against him. and you know, having to go down and play in a league below, which is, you know, it is, you know, we were there for a year. It's a humbling experience going to all the smaller grounds, teaches a thing or two, and Ronnie will just be feeling that, and he knows today's a big stage and he can go out in front of the live TV cameras and he can show his team off and express their great talents. And as I say, he will be looking for this big time today. So,
and isn't it fantastic on this occasion in local Irish League football, we've got one of the world's greatest ever footballers here, Michel Platini, who's now the president of UEFA, here to watch the game this afternoon. It's fantastic, isn't it?
Well, I'm delighted he's back again. He was here the first time with... There he is there. Yeah, haircut's a bit like yours, Stephen.
It's more than me and you.
Fantastic, fantastic player. As I say, the last time he was here was with our own great David Healy, who was rightly recognised. But to have a man of that status here on an occasion like this is absolutely fantastic.
The Northern Ireland manager Nigel Worthington is in attendance today as well. Let's hope everyone enjoys a fantastic cup final. It's time for us to join our commentary team, former league and cup winning manager, now the Glenavon manager Marty Quinn. But first, Jackie Fullerton, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, thank you very much indeed. Former World Player of the Year there, Michel Platini, as you say, brilliant to see him here. He was one of the all-time greats, and he will find a very good atmosphere here in this smaller venue. As Tommy Rice said, a great decision. It's not very often we have a final outside of Belfast. It's Newry City in the Premier League relegation scrap against these men in red, Porto Down, the league leaders in the Championship. It's the first final of this calendar year, and it's an all-country affair. And as we've mentioned, there are the fans from Newry. It's Ronnie McFall, vastly experienced, 29 years in the job, against Gerry Flynn, the new kid on the block. First final, just 2 years into his first job as a manager. John Condry there, who's one of the Porto Down survivors from the 2005 Irish Cup success. And along with Keith O'Hara, he played Wes Boyle, just 3 of them in the team today. Nigel Worthington there. We have the sponsor. There's Mr. Platini, there's the president, Raymond Kennedy, coming behind Michel. That'll be a big thrill for the players, Marty, meeting that man.
Yeah, what a legend, Jackie. Michel Platini, one of the top players in the world, French international many, many times, and an absolutely superstar in his day, and so nice to see him in our humble surroundings here at Mournview Park. It's a real credit to the sponsors in having him over here.
Hugh Wade there at the front of the line, he'll be happy today. They've done a big 2-double in the last 2 weeks at Coleraine.
Absolutely fantastic, Jack. I was there some 8.5 years, and it's a thing I could never do. And all credit to the players and David Platt. I was speaking to David during the week, and he was very much looking forward to the game being in Field on Saturday. And I felt there was a certain amount of confidence from the big man as well. And obviously, he has instilled that to his players, and all credit to them. Fantastic.
And all credit to Michel Platini. It is great to see him here, president of UEFA. And he's at a cup final with just about 3,000 people. He wouldn't have played in crowds that small in the past, but he's here at the grassroots, really, for him, away from international football, top-level football. And he may see a very competitive game. And I think we'll get goals today, Marty.
Yes, I think the early stages of the game are vastly important. You know, you look at Porto Down, they've a lot of experience in their team. They've a lot of players been there, done it before. have won league medal, winners' medals as well as cup medals. If Newry can settle them down and put their mark on the game, they're a very good footballer. Say Jerry has been playing really good football, and if they can sustain the Portadown onslaught probably in the first 15-20 minutes, they have every chance of winning the game. If Newry can get the noses in front, it'll start to give them a lot of confidence and they can go on and win it. You know, everyone would be looking at Portadown as favourites today, but let's not take anything away from Newry. They've got here the hard way as well.
There's the Portadown side, Braniff McCutcheon. They've got 41 goals between them. Boyle Taggart on the flanks, they'll carry a goal scoring threat. McCulloch McCluskey in the engine room, and a very experienced back four.
Yes indeed, Jackie, as I say, there's experience all over. The two central defenders, been there and done it. Middle of the park, Wes Boyle, as you say, scoring a lot of goals, and Taggart on the left hand side, McCutcheon and Braniff up front, 41-42 goals between them, so they're a potent force.
They certainly are. Newry City, seven of this team are playing in their first cup final, but they're strong at the front. Morgan, the top scorer. The big news was that he has been past fit. He was struggling and getting treatment all week and a groin injury. Up front alongside Garrett. Garrett's got, Stephen Garrett, he's got 10 goals this season. Very, very pacey. And in the hole there, the very talented Lee Feeney, who set up both of Morgan's goals in a league game last Saturday. Clark and Ferguson, very good pairing in the engine room there. Keegan and Black on the flanks. And a back three. What about a back three, Marty?
Well, it's something that Newry have been playing all season. You know, they're in a position in the league at the moment which they would like not to be in, but that's working for them probably. But I see the strong points in the Newry team, and Chris Morgan and Lee Feeney, they're both big game players, and perhaps they can produce the goods on the day. Kevin Keegan wide left, a lot of pace. Ross Black down the left hand side of the park, very assured. But I find very much their unsung hero is in the middle of the park alongside Richard Clark, and that's the young lad Ferguson. He works very, very hard. He closes people down, whilst Richie walks away with the all the plaudits. Ferguson's very much an unsung hero, and I'll be watching him very closely today.
Couldn't agree more. I've seen Newry a few times this season, and I've written a note here. Hugely underrated is Mr. Ferguson, who turned 26 on Wednesday. So who knows? The birthday boy may have a good day. That's Braniff, the player of the semi-final. No, it's not Braniff. That's Ferguson, the man we were talking about. There's Braniff there, number 10. And the smaller McCutcheon, 21 goals, Braniff 20. They'll carry the main threat for the men in red. Second final of the season. No big two in sight. It's an all-country final. Newry looking for their first senior trophy since they won the Shield in 1988. 21 years ago, that was their one and only senior trophy. Put it down. They're in the championship because of an administration error, shall we say. But they're in the Cooperative Cup final. They've beaten Cliftonville, they've beaten Linfield, they've beaten Glentoran in the semi-final. Now they have to do it again. Pulled down 5-4 favourites. Outsiders Newry 9-5.
Well, as you say, Jackie, Portadown, you know, they probably deserve to win this trophy because of the fact they've beaten three of the biggest clubs in the country on their way to it. But, you know, on the day, it is on the day, and Newry will not be looking at the record of Portadown, who have they beaten on the way here. They'll be looking to do their own business today.
There we go. There's a bit of bounce to the ground. Braniff blocked there. Good challenge, good block by Cullen Feeney it was. Former Portadown player. Highly rated player, of course, Feeney. 2 years younger than his brother, Lee. Here's Braniff again. Just couldn't control it.
Well, if anyone will want to have a big game today, it'll certainly be Cullen Feeney. Cullen served for Portadown very well for a few seasons. And now he's linked up with his brother, Lee. And two excellent players. You know, sometimes Lee looks a bit, you know, shady at times on the park. He looks a bit lazy. But he's an absolutely outstanding player with great, great ability.
He's an artist, isn't he?
He certainly is.
I was telling him today on the way across the pitch when they were warming up, I said, there's extra time and pens. He said, don't tell me that, Jackie. He says, you know me, I only play for an hour. I said, you've got it up to an hour. So, free kick here. Morgan stopped in his tracks. He's crucial for them today. They'll be pleased that he's out there.
Do you see comparisons with yourself and Lee Finney, perhaps, from your playing days, Jackie?
I never managed near an hour. Thanks for mentioning it, Marty. There's the wall. It's taken quickly. Keeper did well. Stolen away. That's a great double save. Well, well, well. Portadown in real trouble.
Yes, I think Richard actually caught the Portadown defence in the hop there. He took his free kick very quickly and Miskelly got down well, and lucky enough he got there again. It was an excellent save. He got his body in behind the ball and it was a good save.
That was Emmett Friars up there. The big central defender. He's part of the back three, Emmett Friars. He's got four goals this season. Now, I wonder what the thoughts would be of Ronnie McFall at that. An anxious moment. It just shows you there's a little bit of give. He was oh so close, big Emmett there in the picture. But there's a bit of a bobble in that pitch,
there is. It's very lively. Emmett will probably be disappointed he didn't put the ball in the roof of the net from that one.
In comes the corner. Oh, that's a very good header. An excellent header by Andy Hunter. He's got one in this cup run, Andy Hunter. Almost a second. Very close, Marty.
Yes, it was an excellent header. I mean, we're only a couple of minutes into the game. We've had two worthy goal efforts today, one at either end, and that was a powerful header from Andy, one of which I thought was going into the roof of the net.
Big Andy, he's won two Irish Cup medals with Linfield in his time. Now, here's the man we were talking about, Lee Feeney, holding off his marker. Donegan. Good ball by Ferguson, sweeps it wide. Oh dear, Emmett Friars is down. He looks in some distress as well.
Yes, he is actually. I think it might be Ross Black actually.
It's Jackie. Ross Black, sorry.
Yeah, I don't know what Ross has done there. He just he's pulled something obviously, and that would be a pity if he has to come out of the game early days.
See what happens here. Ferguson gives the ball. He's running back. Oh, pulls up there.
That's very strange, actually, Jackie. The hand was raised before the ball came to him, as if he's obviously in pain. Lad. He looks to be getting up on his feet now. It's not too bad, hopefully.
Well, I just wonder, as he was thumping the ground, if it's a calf muscle, he's in trouble. He right. Didn't play last week. Marty in the league game.
Well, perhaps it's a recurrence, but it's looking as if he's going to come back into the game again, I feel.
Well, let's hope so for his sake. Young player, he's just 20 years of age, Ross Black. Nice ball, it was impeded on the way through. He's done well, he's got two in the cup, as you may have seen, free the kickoff. A couple of good ones they were. And he's got 13 for the season from a wide position, which is not bad for a winger.
Very good. Wes, you know, great acceleration, gets away from his marker, crosses great balls, but he also great striker, scores a lot of goals, and some tremendous ones at that.
Keith O'Hara playing right back, but very left-footed, as we'll see here. In it goes. They get it away. It was Friars with the header. Boyle. That will not trouble. Andy Coleman. There's Boyd, a wry smile there. I think he prefers the right side.
Yes, I think judging by that effort, he probably does, Jackie.
Jerry Flynn, he must have thought a couple of minutes ago they were going to go one up, but for a very good double save by Miskelly. Oh, flick on, it's a good one. Taggart. He's dropping behind.
Yeah, that was good pressure from Kevin Keegan, dropping deep there to put the young lad under pressure and made sure that he didn't get a clean cross into the box. And that's what Kevin's going to have to do. They're going to track up and down. Himself and Ross Black will be very, very busy players this day.
Portadown have got 112 goals this season in 37 games. That's more than three a game now. we have to consider some of the opposition, but let's take nothing away from them. You still have to do that, don't you, Mark?
Yeah, that's for sure, Jackie. A goal's a goal, no matter what standard you're playing at in football. You know, you have to hit the target, and they've got into that habit, and obviously that helps their confidence, and it'll certainly help their confidence coming into today's game as well, bearing in mind that they've beaten big clubs on the way to this final, and they probably feel it's going to be their day.
Portadown still trying to get forward. Here's the player of the semi-final, Burnett. Brushed off it. Catching, was looking for the run, but I think Boyle was blocked off, possibly. Not spotted by the referee.
Yes, he was actually. He was impeded there. But you can see young Ferguson once again putting his mark on the game. You know, he's been closing down people and putting his foot in, and he's accented to that.
Here's Ronnie McFall's nephew, Josh Redman, the number three. Branagh, he could hit this, he did, but he hit it poorly. A half chance, which he snatched at.
Yes, he was probably under a bit of pressure, and probably would have liked to have been able to get the ball a bit more under control, but it was a shot just off target.
So Branagh, 10 under 21 caps for Northern Ireland, one under 23 appearance. He's got 5 in the cup run in his 20 for the season.
Yeah, that's a very good return from any standard of football, Jack. He's a big strapping lad. He holds the ball up well also. He brings young McCutcheon into the game. Gary McCutcheon, a lot of his goals are in the six-yard box due to Ronald's presence.
John Conway there, very experienced at the back. Devon gets it forward. But Newry have started well. Portadown maybe finding problems in getting forward.
Yeah, well, I can see the Newry enthusiasm. Jerry's obviously instilled that into the players to close down very quickly, and it looks as if they're doing that quite well, and it's all credit to himself for doing that. And as I say, they've got players, big game players in their team as well who can hurt.
Feeney, lovely control, lovely turn. Friars. Emmett Friars. His brother Sean was at the club, but he's now up at Institute. In by Friars. Morgan couldn't get to it. Keegan inside Richard Clark, the skipper. Cullen Feeney, he'll try his luck. He did, the keeper was scrambling. He lost his footing, I think. And Cullen Feeney was oh so close to his second goal of the season and his second in this cup competition.
That was a great strike, actually, Jackie, from distance. And he just bounced it in front of the goalkeeper as well. Unfortunately for him, it was just a yard wide.
As I said earlier, I think we will get goals.
Yes, up to now, Jackie, we've had three or four attempts on goal, and that's good, because normally in cup finals, teams are very tentative and they don't express themselves going forward too much. But both teams are certainly going end to end.
Here's Boyle. That's great covering again by Cullen Feeney. He read the move, he read where Boyle was going, and he covered it. Now, was Garrett onside? He was.
Yes, Jackie, that was great. Great defender from Cullen Feeney. Not only was he wasn't prepared just to put the ball out for a corner, which a lot of defenders would have done. He was prepared to try and win it, and he won it cleanly and got his clearance.
Here we go. But I suppose Portadown were saying 112 goals this season, allowing for some of the opposition, as we've said, but they find the marking, etc., a lot more difficult today.
There's no doubt about it, Jackie. The Premier League, the 12-team league, has been so competitive this season that every team is capable of beating each other, and everyone has to work very hard, and the concentration of everyone has to be 100%. And you'll find out with Newry that they're going to work hard. They're going to be quicker to the ball than Portadown are used to. But Portadown, let's remember, got here the hard way and then 3 big scalps.
Yep, psychologically, that's a big boost for them. Now, O'Hara, loads of space, chance to look up, chance to deliver the cross. It almost fell. Here's McCutcheon trying to weave a way through. There isn't one. Ferguson, beaten to it by McCluskey, it was. Brian McCluskey, pulled it on midfielder. Centre half cabinet from Manor Gaelic football team. He'll know how to mix it. He's had a good season, I'm told.
Bowman, one of those men playing in his first cup final, the 23-year-old.
Yeah, probably a close call for Jerry as regards the goalkeeping position at the moment. Young Murphy's been doing keeper for most of the season, but obviously the lad Bowman has done well, and he's here probably on there. Just send Ryan McCluskey. Ryan's, you know, a lot of experience. He's been around a few Irish league clubs now, and played in the cup final before with Dungannon when we were narrowly beaten by Linfield. And this crowd will be nothing to him. He's well used to playing in front of maybe 70,000 to 80,000 at Croke Park.
Absolutely. But it's been a lively start to this cup final. Feeney looked like a handball. Three plays on. McCullough got it forward. Here's Braniff.
What you can't see, Jack, it's a lively pitch, and it's in great condition. But both teams are going to try and play football. That's what we can see up to now. They're trying to get the ball down. They're trying to pass it the way the game should be played. There's no real long balls being played up to now. It's all gone through the midfield and passing, and hopefully they can keep that standard up.
Andy Hunter with the long throw. It's a good one. Boyle didn't get there. Liggett did. Taggart did, rather. Redman again. He drills it. Ooh, took a bit of a bounce there.
Yeah, the keeper had his body well behind it. No problem there.
Redman hasn't scored this season. Hard to believe, considering the number of goals they've plundered.
I'm sure his Uncle Ronnie will have something to say about that, Jackie, eh?
Must be difficult playing for your uncle when your uncle's Big Ronnie.
Yeah, but what I will say, the lad is a very composed player and an excellent young player. Let's remember he's still around, what, 19, 20-year-old?
And, that's right.
He's had a couple of seasons over him. I think he's a fine player.
Jerry there in the background. The Navy outfit on, the short pants, not feeling the chill in the air. No, Boyle.
Yeah, just looking over the Newry bench, it's a vastly experienced one with his staff, Peter Murray. Peter's an exported out player. Stephen Beattie, what can we say about Stevie? Stevie's been there and has all the medals in the game. Just see him clapping his hands around, pushing the players on. And certainly if Newry win the cup, there'll be some crack there tonight, I can assure you, with those boys.
Yes, Jerry. He won a league medal with you, Marty, when you were boss up at Cliftonville, 1998. Won the cup at Coleraine as well, 2003, with you.
That's right, and it's funny, it's very humbling. Jerry came to me as I was walking across the pitch, and he said, give me some advice, Marty. And I just said to Jerry, listen, you don't need anything coming from me, son. You're your own man, and you do your own thing.
You want some advice? Panic.
That's something like that, Jackie, yeah.
Lee Feeney was going in there, causing a threat, causing problems. It's a corner. Busy, busy goalmouth. The skipper, Richard Clark, to take for Newry. Keeper came. He didn't really get there. Boyle, very composed, very cool. Gets it away. And again, very few red shirts forward. I think Ronald McFall might want to see more men pushing on. Now, here's Garrett. I haven't seen too much of Stephen Garrett. Richard Clark almost worked with Feeney. He'll fall for Garrett. Tried to place it, but placed it wide. But encouraging.
Certainly is, you know, they're getting the break of the ball, they're getting the bounce of the ball, they look to be having a little bit of luck that you need sometimes, you know, that ball looked just nicely for them, and it's interesting, Jackie, it's pretty even up to now. Both teams have had opportunities, and long may it continue.
Stephen Garrett, who had that snapshot, was named the young player of the semi-final for two goals against Lisburn Distillery.
Yes, he's been a great signing from Linfield, actually. He's done well, he scored a few goals, and he learned quickly playing off Chris Morgan.
And he's got that great asset, Marty, hasn't he? Real pace.
It's a big, big asset in today's game, obviously. As has Kevin Keegan.
No, here's Keegan. Lovely turn. I think Hunter got ahead on that.
Oh dear, complete miscue there. They're having trouble getting it away. Convery it was, and that's a free kick as McCluskey was brought down. But the skipper will be pleased, Richard Clark, how things have gone so far.
Yeah, they've made a really good solid start to the game. They haven't been asked too many questions in their back division, and they seem to be, their system seems to be working quite well.
They feel they're containing the Reds at the moment, Marty, won't they?
Yes, indeed. They'll be very pleased with their efforts up to now.
Boy, there's experience there. That was going nowhere, but he's made sure he got the free kick, and it was a free kick.
Yes, it was, actually, you know.
Silly tackle.
Yes, it was. It was. And, you know, they can utilise that position now and cause danger with Convery and Andy Hunter. Both have moved into the box. Kevin Brunoff, a lot of height in there.
Big man up from the back there, as you can see, in by O'Hara. That'll be too far for all. Central defenders, and you wear one, Marty. You must hate that. You go all the way up. Poor ball, and you go all the way back.
Yeah, I used to find it hard even getting up and see getting back, Jackie. You know, you'd have had to wait for me for a couple of minutes.
Yeah, he'd not be happy, Keith O'Hara. Dunnigan got it forward. Now here's Morgan. We haven't seen too much of Morgan or Garrett, even though Newry are playing a reasonable game. But then we haven't seen too much threat from the other two strikers, McCutcheon and Braniff.
That's very true, Jackie. You know, Chris Morgan's that type of player where you don't see a lot of him until he's sticking the ball in the net. And he's done that, and he's been there. He's a big game player. And I'm sure psychologically, Newry are delighted to have a player of his calibre in their team today.
He's won 5 league championships. He's won 1 Irish Cup. He's won 6 league stroke CIS Cup final, so he's not short in experience, is Armister Morgan. Saw him last week scoring 2 goals down at Dungannon. As you say, you don't see too much of him. Lee Feeney set up the both, he coasted in, finished them 2-0, and they won the game 2-1.
Man of the match, Chris Morgan.
Even though he limped off in the first half with that groin injury, which is trouble him! And that was almost trouble there. Well, well, well. Now, I'd be interested to see that again. The closest Porter Down have come. Dunnigan gets it away. Anywhere will do at the moment. That will have rattled Newry a little bit. Through ball. Flag stays down. Well, the keeper a little bit cool there and casual. But Porter Down have it. It's played forward. And I'm sure we'll see that incident very shortly. So, a little bit of excitement. Porter Down going very, very close. Only the woodwork preventing them going in front. Feeney. Looking for Garrett, that's a good ball. Hunter close with him. O'Hara it was who stepped in. Said, excuse me, takes it away, gets it forward. Emmett Friars. Back to a relieved Andy Coleman, who saw that ball as he could only stand and watch strike the woodwork. Here it is. Good ball in by Hunter it was. Was it Convery that got it? It was. Keeper nowhere. So close.
Yeah, it's a well-delivered free kick on a powerful header from centre-half John Convery, which he's renowned for doing that. And Newry were very lucky there to get away with it, but that's the way it goes.
So the skipper out of luck. McCluskey gave away that free kick, but pulled it on, have it again. Here's Redmond. Taggart, Clark, neat feet. Kevin Keegan, he may have got a free kick. Kevin Keegan played in an Irish Cup final, I think, when he helped Ben Torren beat you, Marty.
2004?
Yes, that's right, Jackie. I know he's
I think he set up the goal that
yes,
day.
Yes, he did. Holiday. That's right, he did. He did for Michael Holliday. And he's a nice Korean player.
Good ball
as well,
from Dunnigan. Sorry, Marty. Great ball from Dunnigan. And there was Morgan all of a sudden making an appearance. He's won the corner. And the dead ball specialist, the skipper, Richard Clark, ambles over to take it. There's Dunnigan up, full back. He had two stitches inserted in an eye cut last week. Paul Dunnigan, tough customer. Yuri corner. Boyle off the thigh, second touch gets it cleared. They've taken it quickly. Ferguson, that's a very good ball. Portadown play themselves out of trouble. It was McCluskey. Now, Boyle. But once again, red shirts thin on the ground as they move forward. Here's McCutcheon. Lovely ball in. Taggart. Oh, great challenge. It was Ferguson. He gets the free kick, McCutcheon. Or does he? It didn't look like a free kick. It's the throw in. McCutcheon and the referee, Mr. McCord, having a verbal battle ongoing.
Yeah, well, I thought Stephen Ferguson won the ball. Yes, he put his foot in, but I mean, it was a fair challenge, and the referee was quite right in waving play on.
Mr. McCourt, he told me he did a countdown from Shield final. He says it seems like about 25 years ago. This is his second final. I suggested he had obviously done well in that final.
He must have done very well.
Conbury. It must be difficult, Ronnie, Ronnie McFall and the team to be playing in the Championship when they are really a Premier League outfit. Must be soul-destroying for some of the players, Marty.
Yes, indeed, but it's looking good for them, actually. They'll be coming up, as if not as winners, probably getting into the playoff. And I just hope it's not against Glenavon at this moment in time, Jackie, because I don't think my heart could hold out for that, you know.
You wouldn't want to meet Portadown in the playoff.
Definitely not.
Here's Ferguson. Clark. Ferguson and Clark starting to show more in that midfield.
I think it was proved early, guys, when Portadown started in the Championship. They lost their first couple of games, and obviously it was hard to motivate the players going to different grounds with no real fan base there. But they've risen from that.
Yeah, they've lost five of their league games. Four of those were quite early in the campaign, I think, when they were still adjusting to their surroundings. Put it on a great run in the league and the Intermediate Cup. He'll know this stat. They've played 37, they've won 30, they've drawn two, they've lost five. They've scored 114, I think I said 112, 114, they've conceded 30 and 37. But they've won defeat in the last 21. They've won 19, they've drawn one.
Yeah, that's a great record by any standards, and that's why they're top in their division at the moment.
Alan Taggart, not able to make any headway. Here's Conrad. The big man is coming forward more and more, continues his run. Redmond couldn't deliver the cross. They'll try to take it quickly. They have. Taggart can swing on it. He has done just that. Just doesn't fall for Portadown. Jerry Flynn will be well pleased the way his team are working, and in particular defending, Marty.
Yes, he will. What I do see is I see Portadown starting to come into the game a lot more now. They're probably getting more confident. I'm just looking at John Conrad. He's joining the attack every chance he gets, and they're quite happy to go man-to-man at the back. And once again, he's up himself and Andy Hunter.
In it comes, keeper. Oh, Coleman did well.
That's a good layoff to Clark as well.
Bit of space. Bit of green grass ahead of Richard Clark. There, here's Garrett, the man of the scintillating pace, being held up. Oh, that's not a bad ball. Ferguson's header. He
could have come out right to Kevin Keegan, didn't see him. Braniff into space to run from McCutcheon. Fullback Redmond making his way in the middle. McCutcheon, I thought he'd overrun it, he probably did.
Yeah, once again, Colin Feeney timed his tackle very well. I actually thought he was giving too much space to the lad McCutcheon, but he closed him down well.
27 minutes gone, 0-0. Oh, there's another morale booster for Coleman. That's a long, long kick. O'Hara was under it. McCutcheon still out left, away from his marker, Donegan. Well, he was, I think, expecting Wes Boyle to make the little dart into the gap. Little Scott frustrated.
Just go back to the goalkeeper, that's the last two crosses you come for, and plucked them out of there. That's great from a defender's point of view, where they don't have to compete and worry about that. I just see Colin Finney slapping, clapping his hands there. That's been great goalkeeping from the lad Coleman. I can see why he's got the vote over the opposite number Murphy today.
Yeah, just 23-year-old, first cup final, might be a few nerves. That would have done him the world of good. Now, here's the man who conducts the Newry Orchestra. Feeney gets it in. The header was by McCulloch. It's a long ball. McCutcheon's away. There's danger here. It's two against one. Braniff is in the middle. Too close to the keeper. That's a chance. Not taken.
That was a big chance, Jackie. Gary looked up and he should have done a lot better. That was a poor pass. A big lost opportunity for Portadown.
Certainly was. It may come back to haunt him, who knows. The two number 11s in competition. Keegan, he might win the free kick. Did the whistle go there for the free kick? Obviously not. Paul Donegan about to take the throw. Taggart. It's all a bit crowded. Portadown get the free kick, a chance to move forward. Ferguson and company have to defend. Picture, Portadown skipper is up. In by Redmond. Feeney was under it. Boyle, McCutcheon can turn on it! And he can finish it! 30 minutes gone, we've had the breakthrough. 22nd goal of the season to send those fans delirious. He's only got two in the cup run. Those will not be important today. He's got one in the final, and he's got the important one, the first one.
Well, let's talk about the header from Wes Boyle. It's just coming to that now, probably. A great header down from Wes Boyle. St. Gary. Gary, as I said, a six-yard predator, 1-0, and you can't give a player of McCutcheon's calibre space like that. He certainly made up for the misplaced pass a couple of minutes ago for Kenneth Braniff.
Big time, big time. And Paul Donegan it was who was closest to McCutcheon, but he was found to be wanting. But as you say, Marty, an ace predator, he turned and he buried it. Now, almost back on terms immediately, but Garrett couldn't get on the end of that.
Yeah, good end-to-end play here, Jackie. Just going back to the goal, as you say, young Donegan, you know, just a temporary lapse of concentration in a cup final. You can't afford to do that. You have to be so tuned in, and you have to watch every move by your opposite marker. But I think all the credit for that goal, in my opinion, goes to Wes Boyle for the cushion header, which he led off into Gary McCutcheon's path.
Yeah, I agree.
A great finish from McCutcheon, though.
Yeah, McCutcheon there in your picture would have enjoyed the goal. But great vision, as Marty says, from Wes Boyle. And that's experience. Now, the tails of Portadown will be up. There is Boyle. can't direct it goalwards.
It's going to be a very important 5-10 minute spell now for Newry. You know, they've got to lock the door now, not let Portadown back into the game. Or sorry, not let Portadown get another strike or another goal. Because if that happens, then it could be a very, very hard game to get back into.
And the favourites, Portadown, the 5-4 favourites, are in front. And I know it's a cliche, Marty, but a goal changes everything, particularly in the final.
Yes, it does, Jackie. I mean, that's bound to give them a sting in their tails now. They're going to be so up for it. They're going to be so confident. As you say, the amount of goals they've scored this season, and they're just keeping their good habits going today, albeit after some 28, 30 minutes or whatever it was. But it was certainly giving them a good confidence booster.
I suppose it depends. Seven of the Newry side have not played in the final. It depends how they react to that setback. They've got to gather themselves. They've got to show that bit of character. That's a much overused word. But they need a bit of grit and determination now, the men in the blue shirts.
As you say, Jackie, there's one thing you can't do in a cup final. You can't take time out to feel sorry for yourself, or you'll be hurt once again. And if they don't get it together shorter, they could be in trouble.
They'll not want to concede a second before the break. The big men are up again. O'Hara takes it short. He gets it back, O'Hara. It's a low cross in. Easy for the keeper. Well, Richard Clark, good ball. That's a good run. He's got Garrett to his right. He's overhit it. It's a poor ball. Well, it needn't have been. Disappointment for the skipper. Poor ball. Good break, Marty.
An excellent break. You know, Richard got himself into a great position. As I say, the pitch is a bit lame, and he just overhit his pass a bit, but it should have been better. And again, it goes back to the pass from McCutcheon for Banff. It was another lost opportunity.
Taggart, he almost kept it in. We were saying when McCutcheon made a mess of that pass, didn't find Braniff. I said, let's hope it doesn't get back to haunt them. It didn't.
Certainly
2 minutes later, they're one up.
Didn't. No, he didn't let it. It didn't let his head down. That's for sure. Great finish. And he's absolutely fantastic. He scores most of his goals in around the 6-yard box area, and some from outside the box as well. A good lad. He's a good striker. He plays on the shoulder. He plays off his. There's a flick-ons. Kevin Braniff's the big man there. He'll get his winners for a fair amount of flick-ons, and the young lad can go through and score.
Yeah, I mentioned Paul Donegan there, but when a striker like that turns as quickly as that, you're usually caught, and they were, and he made them pay. Portadown getting forward again. Here's McCutcheon. Always amazes me that some of the best strikers are small men.
Yeah, that's right. You know, low sense of gravity, they say, Jackie. They can turn very quick and they can get their shots on target. And Gary McCutcheon just epitomised that, as I say, from a great pass from Wesley Boyle.
Braniff thought it was a free kick. Referee doesn't agree. Two Portadown men getting in each other's way. And all of a sudden, there seems to be a spring in the step of the men in the red shirts. Black got it forward. And Ferguson left a couple of studs in there. Gives away the free kick. McCluskey. The skipper, Convery, whose header smacked the bar before they scored. Here's Boyle. By McCulloch. It was not a good ball. City till I die in the background. Those fans are quiet for the moment. 9 minutes to the break. They trail 1-0. Brother McCutcheon, oh, there's a great run here. McCulloch. He's got the corner. Perhaps it could have been a little bit better, but that'll do. It was a good run from the midfielder. Connery, Hunter up again. In it comes. Well, it got over the head of Richard Clark. Garrett. Clark. Garrett wearing the luminous pink boots.
Takes a brave man to wear a pair of boots. That colour, Jackie, is certainly going to be something special. He's going to,
it's a fashion statement, isn't it? Well, sadly for Newry, he and Morgan have yet, I say yet, to stand out. But watch this space.
The longer the game goes on, you can see the confidence in the Portadown squad. They're dealing with anything now that Newry are throwing at them, and they seem quite comfortable, actually. Newry, as they're doing now, they're having to score a lot of passes. When it goes into the last third, look what happens.
Here's Ferguson. Clark. Clark and Ferguson teaming up in the centre of that midfield. That's a nice layoff. Richard Clark going in there. No complaints. I thought he might have been appealing for a corner, Richard Clark. But I think also Newry have got to, Clark there in the picture and Ferguson, they've got to step up the pace a little bit perhaps. And I think they've got to get Lee Feeney on the ball more.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. Lee's just playing in the hole in beside Chris Morgan and young Garrett, and he has got to get more ball because he's a very creative player, Lee. If he can get the ball more often and bring other people in and play a 1-2 with his strikers, yes, I would agree with you. I would like to see more from Richard Clark and Stephen Ferguson. You know, I can't fault their work rate, but I'd like to see them on the ball more and creating more.
Yeah, they've got a bigger impact. I'm sure Jerry Flynn's looking for that as well. But Newry have done all right. They've conceded the goal. That'll be a disappointment to Feeney and company and to the back three who've been very solid. Feeney forward for this free kick taken by the keeper. Connery didn't really judge it. Keegan surrounded by red shirts. Taken away from him. Now, Donegan. Where's Boyle? McCutcheon. Ferguson won it back. McCullough gets it out to O'Hara. Uses the swinger, the right foot. Good touch from Big Emmett Friars. Late challenge there from Boyle.
Yeah, Keith O'Hara just proved to me there that his right leg isn't just for standing on. After all, Jackie, that was a good ball he knocked into the channel.
It was not a bad ball for the swinger, was it?
Indeed, indeed. In what way do you mean swinger, Jackie?
Well, you usually stand on
explain?
It.
No, I see, I understand. Yeah.
I used to have only one foot. It was a good one, mind you, but the right one was... Oh, it was a swinger. You never knew where it was going. McCutcheon, the man who's got the only goal. Lovely little layoff. Redman. That's good covering again by Keegan, but he's given it away. Braniff trying to make space. He was determined. Feeney, lovely turn, little shimmy. Takes him away from McCullough. Lee Feeney, Garrett making a run. Is the flag up? It is.
That's just as we were speaking about, Jackie. That's what I like to see Lee doing more often, picking the ball up from the midfield area, having a go at defenders, creating spaces, drawing defenders out with the support play from young Garrett, unfortunately offside in that position.
Yeah, Garrett with the pace, he just, well, was he? Because the right back might have been playing him on there. Be interesting if we saw that again. But Garrett, well, encouragement for Newry. They need something before the break, which is now about 4 minutes away in this Cooperative Insurance Cup final. McCutcheon got ahead to it. He gave it away. And Ferguson gave it away as well. Put it on through in Keith O'Hara. Boyle. There's a run from McCutcheon. If he sees him, he has. Keeper has blocked it. Second effort, side netting. Almost in for a second, McCutcheon, but not quite.
No, great play from Wes Boyle once again and slipping him in there. And just the angle was a bit tight. The keeper did well for the first, a great save. And then unfortunately, the angle was just a little bit too tight.
But the angle really was against McCutcheon all the way. But good vision again from Boyle. Yes, played him in.
Excellent.
Newry. Morgan! Oh, so unlucky. What a boost that would have been just before the break. Play stop. We have a player down. Convery. So unlucky was Chris Morgan. Top goal scorer for Newry City this season. Garrett did well, was determined. How's that for a hit? Oh!
That was absolutely fantastic. His first touch was top drawer, strike. Thoroughly deserved of a goal, and unlucky for Newry that they're going in there with nothing to show. Once again, it epitomises Chris Morgan. Where's he been for the last 5-10 minutes? He just explodes on the game, and he certainly did there. And they're very unfortunate not to have scored a goal from that excellent effort.
Yeah, as you were saying, his first touch was a good one. The second, dare I say, was even better. And the keeper, Muskelly, he had no chance.
Absolutely no chance.
But that may make Gerry Flynn's team talk at halftime a little bit easier. Garrett, to his credit, was in there causing problems. That's where Convery took his knock.
Yeah, John was brave. He obviously seen young Garrett coming towards him, but he was prepared to put the head in where it hurts, and that's what you expect your centre-half to do, Jackie.
So, coming up to 44 minutes, that will have given Newry a bit of a lift. I was saying it would make Gerry's team talk a little bit easier at half-time. He'll say, well, look what we can do. We can create. All we have to do is convert them into goals.
Yes, indeed, Jackie. As you say, the game's very finely balanced at the moment. If anything, Newry have come into it a bit in the last 5 or so minutes, and they're seeing more ball. And if we can get the wide men into a bit more, Ross Black, Kevin Keegan can give the game a bit more width on the tight pitch, draw the ported down defenders out, and they may get more joy.
So, inside the last minute of the first half, Marty, it's still to play for. You would maybe favour Portadown at this stage, experience, they're one up. But hey, Morgan almost hit back and could do so in the second half.
Yes, I would say, Jack, an overall balance of play at the moment. Portadown probably just about shaded, deservedly going 1-0 ahead. But if Newry could come out and keep the same pattern and the same hunger, they can get something out of this game, as I say. Get the wide men into it a bit more.
Here's Branagh. McCutcheon, the man who got the only goal, but a bit heavy with the touch there, trying to find Alan Taggart. 2 minutes will be added on at the end of this first half. His goal came after 30 minutes. And we've been close to others since, none closer than at the other end, Chris Morgan.
Yes, sir, right indeed, Jackie. Let's not forget, Newry have had a couple of good opportunities as well. And as you say, Chris's Thunderbolt hit the crossbar. But they've had a couple of other chances where the final passes just went astray.
Winners today will get £15,000. The runners-up, beaten finalists, get £11,000. Big prize money from very good sponsors, Cooperative Insurance. They've just extended their League Cup deal by another 2 years. That'll bring them up to 10 years. Big supporters of football,
yes,
all over
great.
The British Isles. And we're very grateful for it here in the Irish League, Marty.
Yes, indeed we are, Jackie. Say the colour here today and the decision to bring the game here to Moonbeam Park is the right one, as Tommy Wright said earlier on. And there's a good atmosphere. There's 3,000 or so people in the ground. And I would say that everyone's enjoying the game, including the Newry fans who are down 1-0 at the moment, but I'm sure they believe that their team can get back into it again.
And I'm sure Michel Platini, the UEFA president, former world superstar, will have enjoyed the effort of the game.
Yes, indeed, Jackie. Obviously, the standard of football Michel Platini's used to looking at is way above this. But you see honest effort out there, and I'm sure he's enjoying that because he's looking at real people, not like some of the
superstars we have on display at the moment. Some of them really get on my net, to be quite honest with you, with their carrying on.
Temper your language, sir. Lovely touch there from Lee Feeney. Solid touch there from McCluskey. As the referee brings it to an end, it has been, as Marty was saying, for the neutral, very interesting. We've had near chances, we've had near misses. His side go one up. McCutcheon, after 30 minutes, there he is, his 22nd goal of the season. That goal separates the two sides at halftime.
Well, here in the studio with me, the Linfield and Crusaders managers, David Jeffrey and Stephen Baxter. David, give us your assessment of what was a very entertaining first half.
Entertaining, enthralling. I thought it was a fantastic, fantastic advert for local football. And I've got to congratulate the IFA for bringing the final here, because the ground is superb, nice and compact, loads of supporters in. Both teams had their chances, but I've got to say, in the first half, I think Portadown shielded it. And what a fantastic goal from Gary McCutcheon. Superb.
Stephen, a half-packed with incident, wasn't it?
Oh yeah, there's been 3-4 chances for both teams, you know, but Portadown, as David has said, look, the more superior side, they're passing it better, they're getting through the midfield quicker, and they're getting supply up to their front men, which is what you want. So they'll be happy with their first half performance. But an entertaining game, both teams here to play football, try and win the game. Morgan's effort there at the end might have just brought the game level and would have been set up nicely the second half. But really, really pleased. I'm sure the fans are enjoying it. We're certainly enjoying it, so it's been good.
Yeah, bar that Chris Morgan effort at the end of the half there. Portadown have been a lot busier up front though, haven't they?
They have been busier up front, but later on we'll see a couple of shots from an early chance. You know, a great Richard Clark free kick, and Emmett Fires, you know, maybe should have done better. But I think Portadown have dominated. You know, you think a great header from Andy Hunter, big John Convery, you know, hit the bar. Obviously, Gary McCutcheon has scored. He had another chance after that. They've created more. Wesley Boyle has been the instigator. He's got the ball. He's attacked him. He's got down the sides. And with Newry playing three at the back, there are gaps down the channels. And they've exploited them on occasions, particularly the movement, I've got to say, of McCutcheon and Boyle. McCutcheon has worked tirelessly into the channels and has done tremendously well.
OK, thank you very much for the moment. Of course, the UEFA president is here, Michel Platini, today, taking a keen interest in the game. We can hear from him now live.
He's also taking a keen interest, Stephen, in the kids who are playing behind us at the grassroots initiative. He's actually just dribbled the ball back out to the Michel. You haven't lost it. You're very welcome here to this final. Have you been enjoying it?
Yes, a lot.
I know that you're here debating some of the big issues of the game, and one of them you've talked about is the 6-5. It will particularly please you, I imagine, that all of the players out here, if you like, they are homegrown.
Of course. I saw. No, but for me, this football today respects when I played some years ago, the spirit, the fighting spirit, the British, and an old-fashioned football played by these players, and I seem to be in the real football, and I am in the real football, and that is very nice. But of course, homegrown players are important. We have to keep the identity of the team, because the fans, they want their player of the city, the region, and the country. But now it's difficult.
Of course, you are a former World Player of the Year. The last time we spoke to you, you were here presenting David Healy with the boot for having eclipsed Davo Šuker. I'm wondering how important it is for players like today to have someone like you here, players who are never going to perform probably at an international level.
I think these players, they are playing for themselves, not for the crowd. They are playing to win the cup. They are playing their passion, and that is the most important. We are not forgotten that the football is a passion. It's a passion for the players and for the wonderful fans of Ireland.
Final question. You're enjoying the hospitality. Will you come back to visit us?
I am president of 53 National Association. I am not a product of British or Irish. I have to travel Monday, Tuesday. Go to Macedonia, to Serbia, and to Moldavia. I have to travel.
One of the few French words I know is peut-être, Stephen. That's perhaps he'll be back. Thank you very much, Mr. President. Back to you in the studio.
I think he was just expected to say yes they were there, wasn't he?
Well, I think in this day and age, the parlance would say that that was a very challenging interview for Mark Sidebottom there. I think he did extremely well. And I hope Mr. Platini will come back to Ulster again, because we are the warmest people in the world.
Stephen, it is great to have a man of his stature here at Little Mournview Park today watching some Irish League football, though, isn't it?
Well, I think it's good for him to come and see what we can do here. You know, this facility has come on such a long way in the last few years, and it's good that Northern Irish football is seen in that light now. And it's good to have people like that of his stature come to our games.
OK, well, let's take a look at some of the first half incidents. The game got off at a great pace, didn't it? Some couple of early chances.
It's absolutely tremendous, Stephen. Here was a great free kick for Mitchell Clark. Very, very clever. Everybody's standing static. Emmett Farrell reacts first, and Big Mistake. Skelly does tremendously well. Here's a header from Andy Hunter, ever so close. You know, very, very dominant, and no one was getting anywhere near him.
And both teams, Stephen, they got a chance. They were almost shooting on sight. They were setting their stall out very, very early, as we can see here.
Yeah, the chances came thick and fast right from the very start of the game. And you know, this was Kenneth Braniff just got a shot off target, but he's been great this half. And then we'll see another opportunity here for, well, that's the reverse angle. So it was a great effort from Braniff. He's a good player. And then Newry, they were also coming at the game well. Big shot here from Colin Feeney. And that was very close, actually, just a yard. We were looking right down on it. Came into him, took the strike nicely, kept his head over it. Great effort.
The message from both managers was obviously, you get a chance early on. Come on, let's try and take it.
Well, if you don't shoot, you know, you don't score. And it has been really, really pleasing to people that, you know, to be so enterprising. And as I say, Stephen, you know, summed it up tremendously well there. Colin Feeney, defender, steps into the middle of the park, takes the ball forward, and a great strike from him. So it doesn't matter where it's coming from, it doesn't matter where players end up, they're prepared to have a go, Stephen.
And that point exactly, John Convery did exactly the same. We can take a look at his header here. Great chance.
I mentioned him in the build-up, Stephen. He's an absolute tar of a man, and that is a superb, superb header. Look how he gets up. Sam out of the water, vision of an eagle, and bang, look at that, my goodness gracious me, and look at how the crossbar rattles. Great effort.
Let's talk a bit about Gary McCutcheon. He's been particularly busy, hasn't he, in the first half?
Well, Gary McCutcheon's a player I've really admired for maybe 5, 6, 7 years now. His movement off the ball is what creates the chances for him.
And this one he'll be particularly unhappy with, I'm sure.
Yeah, well, he slipped his marker well, and he's got himself in a nice position, but then he's put an awful poor ball into the box there. It's very simple, but, you know, we'll now see the quality of the man here. You know, it's a great win here by Wesley Boyd with the header. But what's his finish? Just quick turn, bang, you know, keeper no chance. So that's the type of him. He's made a career out of goals like that.
Sign of a true striker there, David. He didn't even glance. He knew where the goal was.
Instinctive. This big fella beside me was a fantastic, fantastic striker. He really was superb, and that would be a goal that Stephen would have been proud of. You know, and I think great credit's got to go to Ronnie McFaul, because Gary first, you know, plied his trade with Larne, and with the greatest respect to Larne, you know, Ronnie went and looked. And maybe a lot of players would have thought, or a lot of managers would have thought, well, should we go after this lad? And I think Gary McCutcheon's attitude today, his work has been phenomenal, but the goal was absolutely first class, instinctive, didn't even have to look, just buried it.
And even as the game progressed, more chances. We had a couple right before half time.
Yeah, you know, again, great movement off the ball, gets a shot away early, and ball comes back to him. He just doesn't get the connection he wanted the second time round. But look at that there for effort. You know, it's running off the ball, it's so hard to pick up as a forward when you make that move early. And then we see Newry here coming in. What a strike from Chris Morgan. You know, he nearly ripped the net out with it.
The woodwork was shaking there, wasn't it?
It's been shaking on a couple of occasions. Young Stephen Garrard did very well. He was very brave. Martin in his commentary, you know, commented about John Convery going for the ball. You know, when you look at John in comparison to young Stephen Garrard, but Stephen went in, ball dropped to Christopher. And, well, I know Christopher from way back in 2004, 2005, the Morgan day. And my goodness gracious me, that was typical of the man. Fantastic strike, and very unfortunate that it didn't go into the back of the net.
We'll chat more in a moment. I'll just hold you there for a second. Time to hear from the Northern Ireland manager, Nigel Worthington.
Thank you very much, Stephen. Last I was talking to you was in San Marino. That was a good night. You're equally enjoying this afternoon's fair, Nigel.
I am. I think it's a very good game. The two teams are very evenly balanced, and the goal separates the two of them at this moment in time, but there's not a lot to separate them, really.
Has Gary McCutcheon impressed you?
Well, the goalie scored. He took it very well on the turn from the bottom corner of the net. But overall, the quality of play, the pitch is very flat, but it's very bubbly. And I think both teams have dealt with that very well. There's been some good football. And also, into the bargain, I think the referee, the officials have had a good game, which is important to mention them as well.
Yeah, and just before you came across to me, so wasn't it great to see Michel Platini here? And presumably you've had a word with him.
Yeah, we've had a discussion before the game and during the game, and it's great to have a person of that magnitude, the player that he was and what he represents now in world football, and to have him here today to see this game and be part of what is a very good cup final.
Any international news that you can regale us with, or is it all quiet on the international front?
It's one of those stages at the moment, Mark, where it's in between the games, and it's very, very quiet. So as long as everybody's fit and playing for the team, that's the main thing at the moment. But all quiet, and that's good news.
I know you wouldn't have missed today. Pre-kickoff, we were talking to your former international and indeed Ballymena colleague Tommy Wright. He's making the point, what a great call for the powers that be to have brought the game here to Morrenview Park. I take it you're in agreement with that.
Well, I think it's a great idea. One, because it's very much more or less central to both clubs and ideal from a travelling point of view for the supporters. And when whatever the crowd's been, 4,000 in a stadium like this compared to maybe in Windsor Park, which would be almost empty, to get the atmosphere. It's good for the players, good for the supporters, and I think it's refreshing for the game. It's good to see Newry out of the Premier League in the final. It's great to see Ronnie McFall and Portadown trying to claw their way back into the top level in the cup final today. So overall, very good.
Career in politics awaits. You've just about ticked every box there, Nigel. Let's back up to the boys and Stephen. Thanks.
Cheers, Mark. Thank you very much indeed. We were chatting about the Newry striker, Chris Morgan, a player you know all about, Stephen. Had that great chance just before halftime.
Yeah, Chris Morgan started at Crusaders as a young boy. Came into the first team from Saintfield United. And I knew right away, playing alongside him, I knew he had the talent to go all the way. He's shown his ability today. He's got a wonderful first touch, Stephen. Spins people at a hair's breadth, gets a shot away early. And we've witnessed out there today. And he's got a pure strike of the ball. And he's scored many goals through his career, you know. And it's just unfortunate now. He's picking up a few injuries like us all. Getting a little bit old, you know. And you know, but Chris Morgan is a match winner. And he might go out here in the second half and get his head on something or his foot on something and get Newry back into the game.
Yeah, David, Newry's still well in this game.
There's absolutely no doubt about it. As I say, Christopher's shot at the tail end, you know, showed us what potential they have. I do think they need to get more of the ball to Lee Feeney. What a wonderful talent, you know. Nicknamed the golden child at his time at Linfield. A precocious talent and a gorgeous young man. Really is a superb fella. But they need to get him on the ball more. They really, really do. And if Lee can get at the ball, if he can get it, you know, the back four have poured it out, then hopefully they will open them up for Newry's sake.
One man who has been on the ball, of course, is Gary McCutcheon, who we've been talking about there. We've got another angle of his goal we can take a look at, Stephen.
Yeah, it's a good delivery into the box as well, you know, and Newry have dealt early with it, got a good head on it. But here's a great leap here from Wesley Boyle, gets it back in the danger area, and that spin and turn strike, it's just instinctive, you know, you just don't stop those. He's made a really good contact, kept his head down. He knows where the back of net is, this young man.
So it's Portadown from the Championship, playing in the lower league, beating the team from the Premier League. But let's be honest, if Portadown were in the Premier League, where do you think they'd be sitting at the moment, David?
I think they would certainly be in the top six, there's no doubt about that. And I think credit has got to go to the likes of Roy McMahon, who have, you know, really supported the club. You know, a lot of people maybe would have turned and walked away. Yeah. But you have good Portadown people who support Portadown.
And out in force today as well.
Fantastic support today, yeah. as I realised on the way round.
You got a bit of stick.
I got a little bit of friendly abuse.
I think it's fair to say, David, we're missing them as well in the league. You know, it'll be good to have them back because they're great side.
It'll be tremendous to have them back. As I say, they've done an awful lot of work in terms of the ground. The stadium is really set for the Premiership. Very unfortunate about the reason why they're not there. But we're hoping very much they'll be back next year.
Okay, thank you for the moment. We can now hear the thoughts of Tommy Wright.
Hi, Stephen. It'll come as no surprise, Tommy, that the Portadown fans are in full voice behind us. Do you expect that they will be singing in 45 minutes' time?
Well, who knows? I mean, the one thing, it's been an entertaining first half, and there's been good chances for both teams. The thing is, Portadown and McCutcheon have taken their chance. I think there'll be more chances, and basically it'll just be, you know, who's going to come out on top? It's going to be the team that takes those chances.
just under an hour ago we stood here and it was pretty much dead calm, and what the boys won't maybe notice up the studio, the wind is really getting up down here at pitch side. Are you expecting that to be a factor second half, Tommy?
Yeah, it could well be. I mean, you've seen the first half, Coleman of Newry was launching the ball quite long and trying to get Garrett and Morgan in behind the two centre halves. You know, that'll be the Portland Downs advantage. Sometimes it can be their advantage. It may suit Newry a wee bit in that the ball will hold up if they can get it behind Portland Down and down the side off them.
We'll wrap it up there, Tommy, and go get wrapped up ourselves. Back up to you, Stephen.
Thank you very much indeed. The players are taking the pitch for this second half. It's been a very entertaining cup final so far. Newry losing to Portadown by 1-0. Can they turn it round in the second half? We can find out with the help of our commentators Marty Quinn and Jackie Fullerton.
Thank you very much indeed, Stephen. Nice to hear the boys in the studio there. David getting a little bit of friendly abuse on the way around. I saw that. Yeah, it was friendly. It was friendly. Here come the Reds. They're one up. Skipper leads them out, John Condrey. Nice that Michel Platini said it's like British football, it's real football. But what will the managers have been saying at halftime? What will Gerry have been saying to get back into this game?
Well, Gerry will be asking his players to maybe push themselves a bit harder to try and give. I would like to see them giving them a bit more width. I'd like to see Keke and Blackie, Ross Black, both hugging the lines a bit more and creating a bit more space, perhaps to receive a pass. With Keegan's pace, he certainly can go past the fullback and get a few crosses into the box. As you were just saying to me off the airways, Jackie, the game has passed Lee Feeney a bit. You know, maybe he can get himself into a better position this half if they want to go maybe three up and have a go at it. What's the point of getting beat 1-0 or 2 or 3, 4-0? Try and get something back out of it again. And obviously, once again, the first 10 minutes, very important. Newry don't concede a goal. If they do, the game is virtually over. And that's what Ronnie McFaul will be enticing his players to do. Try and go for the juggler in early days and kill the game off. And with the experience they have in their team, I couldn't see any way back for Newry after that.
Yes, another Portadown goal could be the death knell, but we shall see. 45 minutes left. We will have extra time and penalties. It will be played to a finish if required. And Newry, how will they be feeling against a team from the Championship? But they know that team is Portadown and they really are a Premiership outfit. But just looking at Ross Black down in front of us here, the number three, he seemed to be limping a little bit as he came out, but he's not too bad.
I'm sure Gerry and the rest of the staff will be reminding the players of the few opportunities they had in the first half. You mean they had two or three chances where they could have scored, the thunderbolt from Chris Morgan also, and if they can get balls in, players of the calibre of Garrett and Morgan will stick the ball in the onion bag if you get them in, as will Lee Feeney. So they've got to try and pressure a wee bit more, maybe play a higher line.
Yeah, and that thunderbolt, as you describe it, from Chris Morgan will be fresh in the mind. It was just before the break. McCutcheon's goal came after half an hour to break the deadlock. Here's the man who set it up, Wes Boyle, going alone. Still going, Wes Boyle. This is a great run and a good ball in. Not good enough. But early danger there from Boyle and Portadown.
Yes, it was, Jack, and as you said, it broke down the right-hand flag. I'm just looking very closely at Ross Black, and I don't think Ross Black is fit to be on the pitch at the moment. I think the lad's still carrying an injury. I'm looking at him. He's walking, as you can see now. He's not walking very well. He's limping when he's running. So
yeah, I mentioned that. I thought he had a little bit of a limp when he was coming out. Yes, he is. He's running towards us now. And his game might soon be up. We shall see what happens there.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to be very comfortable, Jackie, actually.
And Newry, they've got
well, I would look at their
they've got Darren King at fullback, Tony Anderson, they've got Johnny Gowdy.
I would look at Paul Walsh and
Paul Walsh, your winger.
Paul,
yeah.
Walsh, natural left-sided player, could probably go into that position and maybe give them a little bit more.
Yeah, here is the man we're talking about. Good touch. He just doesn't look sharp though, Ross Black. Feeney crowded out of it. They're doing quite a good marking job on Feeney as well, has to be said, for it down. couldn't thread it through. Richard Clark almost picked up on it, not quite. Here's Feeney, the artist, turns away. Bit of a cul-de-sac though, being forced away from goal by McCluskey. He's got the free kick. Now, good position for the free kick for Newry. There may have been an elbow up there from Mr. Feeney. He's either smiling there or trying to get his breath.
Yes, he did very well, Jackie, in getting a free kick there because he was going nowhere, but his body strength was very good and he held the defenders off.
Richard Clark delivers too close to the keeper. No problems for David Muskelly. Made a good double save in the first half in the opening minutes. Here's the goal scorer, McCutcheon. Inside Boyle, there's the bubbly pitch that we were talking about. Keith O'Hara wants to turn, deal with it. Delivers it with the favoured left foot, McCutcheon. Friars, it was, got it away from him. Morgan having to come deep. Andy Hunter off the head of Black. Oh, lovely flick, but the flag will be up against Braniff. Good run, he just started too early, Kevin Braniff. Lovely little flick, good vision from McCutcheon. As you were saying, you get the sense that Portadown believe.
Yeah, Jackie, experience is a great thing in football. Been there, done it, and have all the T-shirts in the locker, and they're just saying to themselves, now what we have, we hold. Let's not give anything away. But, you know, Newry had a free kick there, and I thought it was an excellent free kick from Richard Clark. He put it into a great area, but unfortunately his teammates didn't anticipate it going in there, and all it needed possibly was a touch.
And as you know, Marty, a goal for the men in blue, it would be a very different complexion in this cup final.
No doubt about that, Jackie.
O'Hara. As you say, Newry, they've got to step up, got to increase the tempo. Now, Feeney. Oh, it's a lovely ball. Morgan. Good block it was by McCluskey. Portadown have it. Boyle, McCutcheon. Hospital ball. And Mr. Friars. Might be the first yellow card of the afternoon. Left a foot in, as they say. Typical defender's tackle when you want to stop somebody, Marty.
Yes, it was actually. Just a little late, I would say.
Just a tad.
Being a sympathetic defender.
He's not one of your players. You don't have to defend him.
That's
Marty.
For sure. That's for sure.
We've got a balloon on the pitch, but Andy Hunter chooses the right one to hit. Portadown corner. Emmett Friars, confirmation of that yellow card. He'll have to be careful. On this bobbly sort of pitch, you have to be careful with the tackling.
I'm sure the losing manager will be saying he had a few balloons on the pitch, Jackie.
Oh, keeper, well, he did well. Yeah, he put Conbury off in the end.
Once again, he was very positive. Came for the cross, unfortunately, slipped through his hands. And lucky for him, Conbury was unfitted.
He did enough.
He did enough, indeed.
Good long kick. It's a lovely, fresh day for the last day of February. A little bit of a chill in the air, and there's not very much breeze on the pitch. A little bit. Donegan with the throw. That'll be a free kick.
Yeah, the conditions are fine for football. The pitch is in great condition also for the time of the season, Jackie. It's flat and okay, the game is, it's the pitch is lively, but it's quite flat. All credit to our ground staff here at Mournview Park.
Good plug, Marty.
George Savage, I better say his name. He told me to, or I'll be in trouble on Tuesday night when I want to train on it.
Here's Feeney.
Sorry, that should have been George Swift.
George Swift. First thing he forgets a name, you know. It's an age thing. Harry.
You're talking from experience there, Jack.
I'm talking from personal experience.
Yeah.
Well, the second half is yet to take off, 7 minutes into it. Big Ronnie there. He's one up, but you'd never know it. He always has that expression. Somebody said the world's against him. He's actually very good company, our Ronald. Friars, he's given it away though. Forward by Mr. McFall's nephew, Redmond. Good take by Taggart.
What I like about Ronnie, you know, what you see is what you get. There's no hidden agenda with him, and his enthusiasm for the game is probably, I mean, I've known Ronnie a long time now, and his enthusiasm is still the same as it was since I got to know him going into management, and it doesn't seem to be waning at all. He seems as hungry and as passionate as ever.
Oh, absolutely. And don't cross him. Fiery temper.
I'm saying nothing, Jackie.
You've had your moments as well. Well, Andy Hunter, I'm not quite sure what he was dallying about there. But they get it away. Flyers in there. Richard Clark. The run from Garrett. Hunter doing well. Well, good experience there from Andy Hunter.
Yes, he did everything right. He held the player off, but you could see that little bit of pace there that could hurt them if they got the right balls into young Stephen Garrett. He could certainly hurt you, but at the moment, they just haven't given the quality ball in the channels for either him or Chris Morgan. And as I say, Lee Finney's just sitting in behind, and he's coming into the game now and again, but not enough for my liking.
Yeah, we're talking about Andy Hunter there. It's lovely to see him back because I saw him one night. I was watching a match at my hometown club, Ballymena United, and he got a bad injury. He was playing for Crusaders at the time, bad knee injury, and it was not good. He was out for a long time. So it's good to see him back, and he's playing in a cup final. Boyle, Feeney, it was off his chest. Boyle, clever stuff. Feeney, doing a good tidying up job.
In fairness to Lee Feeney, he's put a lot of work in. As you can see now, he's back in his own, in the last third of the pitch, in his own half, and he's worked hard, very, very hard.
Yeah, and Newry know that they've got Morgan, they've got Garrett up front, a little bit of magic from Feeney. He turns things their way as they seek an equaliser. 10 minutes into the second half, still 1-0, Portadown. McCutcheon got the goal. Here he is spraying it, he's given it away though. Feeney was in the way. Hunter, easy ball to find O'Hara.
As we just seen him there a minute or two ago, Jackie, Richard Clark on the ball. We haven't seen enough of Richard this afternoon for my liking. Normally, any time I see him, everything goes through him, and today it hasn't been really happening.
No, we were saying in the first half that he and the player I must say a big liking for, Stephen Ferguson, they haven't made a big enough impact. As you say, you can't fault their work rate.
No.
But they need to express themselves. And
well, I think the midfield have cancelled each other out. Ryan McCluskey and
David McCullough.
They've marshalled Clark and Ferguson. But, you know, of the four, none of them have really done anything. That's what I'd like to see Kevin Keegan doing more, picking up the ball in a deep position and running at the Portadown defenders. Kevin's very good at that, still has a lot of pace.
He has indeed, 29 years of age now, Kevin Keegan, the man with the famous name. It's just not happening for Newry.
in the last third of the pitch. Strength from Braniff. Good distribution as well to find McCutcheon. O'Hara herring down wide. Finds him. Danger here. That's a good block by the man we were worried about his fitness, Ross Black. Well done, that young man. McCulloch. He hit it, but he hit it well wide. Five goals this season, David McCulloch. He hasn't scored in the cup run, and he hasn't scored in the final.
Nice to see a young player coming into the Portadown team, scoring a few goals, having the confidence to have a pop at it.
Here's Hunter. It's into the gardens behind us. Morgan. He hasn't had too many chances to shine, Chris Morgan, but he found the space just before the break and almost made Portadown pay. Portadown defending Muskelly. He's lost it, but he was bundled off the ball. The referee decides. Big fella, David Muskelly. Didn't play in the semi-final, but he's here because Neil Armstrong has got ankle ligaments. Neil Armstrong couldn't even take his place in the bench today. Instead, that goes to a young 17-year-old keeper, Andy Wright. What an experience for him, even to sit on the bench. You'd remember a day like that if you were 17, Marty?
Yes, he certainly would, Jackie. Just going back to the Muskelly incident there, you know, I think the goalkeepers are overprotected. I don't think there was anyone going in there and doing any more than Muskelly was doing himself. Well, both players were attacking the ball. Muskelly drops it and the referee gives a free kick out.
I wouldn't argue with that.
Well, Jackie, I mean, I've seen it last week at Windsor Park. Sorry, at the Oval, Stephen Firth.
Just a minute, here's Boyle. And Cullen Feeney helps it on its way. Sorry, you were saying, Marty.
Yeah, Stephen Carson went up with Elliot Morris, Glenn Torn, goalkeeper. And most people thought that Carson fouled the keeper, but in my eyes it wasn't the case. Both players had their eye on the ball. Stephen was brave and went for it. The ball broke to him and he stuck the ball in the back of the net. And lo and behold, the referee let the goal stand. I thought it was good refereeing.
Well, there's sharp refereeing there. A bit of back chat from Cullen Feeney. And he's the second booking of the day. Feeney and Friars, both of Newry, in the referee's notebook. Mr. McCourt, as the boys were saying at half-time, he's not missed too much, the referee. And he certainly heard the back chat there from Mr. Feeney. But that might be a touch of frustration. When a cup final's running away from you, it's not easy. Make sure the red mist doesn't descend at times.
Yeah, I think Lee's starting to get a bit frustrated now, and you know, that might be a bad thing, because sometimes when you get a player up and you get him a bit angry and a bit annoyed, you'll get more out of him. And he's a player very capable of turning things up, and he could be a match winner on his own.
He certainly could. Here's Donegan. Almost kept it in. Redman wants to take it quickly. So strong. Redman not strong enough. But again, Garrett and Morgan really having to feed off scraps up front, aren't they?
They're very isolated, Jackie, you know, and you see that ball being passed there. The midfielders weren't backing them up. You know, the two wide men, Kevin Keegan should have been up further up the park as well, you know, but at the moment they're just playing into Portadown's hands.
It's an easy game from up here, Marty, isn't it?
Yes, it certainly is, Jackie. It's a very good game and it's quite enjoyable. But you know, maybe I'm a bit.
No, you can see things. You can see things from up here as well.
I can see things from here as well, Jackie. Yeah.
And what you're saying is right. They've got to get forward more. Taggart, shouldn't be any problems. It isn't. put up there. A look of determination on his face. He'll not be giving it up. We're just over the hour mark at Mournview Park in this Cooperative Insurance Cup final. 30 minutes. McCutcheon got the goal for Portadown, which separates the sides. We've had other chances, but it's been a very quiet second half, particularly from Newry. You would expect more from Newry, who are looking for their first trophy in 21 years. There's only their second senior trophy. Cash Antrim Shield was in their trophy cabinet in 1988. Nothing since. Portadown, they haven't had a trophy since the Irish Cup 4 years ago. But they're both in the Irish Cup next Saturday. So they are. I think Portadown are at home to Crusaders. Our studio guest Stephen Baxter will not be looking forward to that as Baraniff shows his frustration. That is not worth a booking, referee. I'm sorry. Can't agree with that one.
Well, I think Kevin probably got it wrong there. He's shown a lot of frustration, but in my opinion, he was offside when the ball was played. A fantastic ball from Andy Hunter, but in my opinion, he was offside. And the referee got it, you know, he got it right.
Oh, he got the decision right, but the booking? He bounced the ball.
I don't know what he said, Jackie.
Well, that's true. That is true. I was saying Portadown at home to Crusaders next Saturday, the quarter-finals of the Irish Cup. Newry City, they are away to Institute. And as he sits in our studio, enjoying the game, enjoying the afternoon, Stephen Baxter, great chance for him to spy on those opponents next week. He'll certainly not be taking any team of big Ronnie McFalls lightly. Here's Feeney, Lee Feeney. Flyers. Didn't get to Lee Feeney. It has now. Black keeps it in. Chance to put in the cross. It wasn't a good one. Ferguson. Emmett Friars, that's not a bad ball. Keeper came a long way, not sure he got anything on it. But Portadown, clear the danger.
That's better for Newry now, Jackie. A couple of balls knocked in around the central defence area, and you never know, anything could happen when you keep getting balls in on a constant basis. Keep the pressure on.
You say Portadown, they know they don't have to give anything away. The cup will be theirs. Things can happen in the blink of an eye. Braniff, cool play. Forward by O'Hara. Morgan turns straight into O'Hara. Here's Braniff again. Lovely ball into space for David McCulloch. Here's Redmond. Down the line for Leggett. Flag is up on this side. Camera just to our right. Screwing the view of the linesman. Difficult to see when the flag's up. But it was. And Newry Town, we're talking about Portadown's great run. One defeat in the last 21 games. Newry, after a dreadful run of six defeats and a draw, they've won four of their last six games. They've won the last two before today, away at Dungannon last week and at home to Bangor in the Irish Cup the previous week. They scored three goals. Morgan got all three. Wes Boyle hoping to make it 2-0. He can't. Perhaps he should have, but the ground, the bubble in the ground may have beaten him.
Yes, I think that was his downfall, actually, Jackie. Great strength, great running, great pace. And just as I say, I think it was just a slight bubble when he was making contact with the ball and it went over the top.
Good run, though. He left Excellent. Colin Feeney for dead. He did lean back a bit, though.
Yes, he did, Jackie. Yeah, he should have got his body over it much more. But, you know, credit the boy for the strength and ability to get in that position.
Almost 2-0. Perhaps it should have been. And that could have been that, as they say. But here come Newry. Here comes Morgan. This is good. Kevin Keegan. Oh, Morgan blocked. Nothing is going the way of Newry City. Keegan, the man in your picture there, out of luck. And they must be wondering, Newry City, as they get a free kick, what they have to do to score today.
That was a great strike from Kevin. So unlucky. Great layoff from Chris. Great shot. So unlucky the ball didn't rebound a bit of a better angle for Chris. Just too many bodies in around him, but certainly Kiki will be so disappointed.
Well.
That's what you need now. That can maybe give him the lift and drive him on. I'm just looking at the Newry, they're back three, and they haven't been extended for quite a period of time now, so they're coming into the game more.
Ferguson takes that. Feeney is up there. A little bit of pushing, perhaps. Richard Clark stuck it in the onion bag, but it will not count. Shake of the head from the 33-year-old Morgan. But three-quarters of the way through the game, a reminder there that it's not over yet.
No, it is not indeed, Jackie. And as time goes on, I would expect, just looking at Jerry there, I would expect Jerry to be more positive shortly and perhaps go 3-4-3, get an extra man up front. And my player to do that would be Kevin Keegan. I would push him wide right up along with Morgan and Garrett.
Here they are trying to get forward. Garrett, chance to run. He's running at Hunter. He's cutting inside. Oh, it's fallen here for Morgan. Keeper did so well. The angle slightly against the ace marksman. But 10 out of 10 to the keeper, Marty.
Yes, indeed. All the plaudits go to the goalkeeper. I could see what Chris was trying to do. He was trying to just flick it over him. But what a great position. Off the ball, Lee Feeney was in, the square ball to Lee Feeney, and I'm quite sure Newry would have had an equaliser.
All of a sudden, the game has come to life, and it had to. Braniff tried from a cutchin. Oh, a bit of a scrambly pass there off the chest of Colin Feeney.
I think the fans behind the goal are calling for a handball there. It was a dodgy one.
That's the man there in your picture, McCutcheon, who's got the only goal so far. My goodness, the score could be about 3-2, I think, at the moment. 3-3.
Jackie's finals goal has been very entertaining. You know, both teams have come out with the determination to win and to play football, and it's been excellent up to now.
Yeah, that's why I said at the top of the game, Marty, I thought we'd get goals today, because I was looking at the players involved, and they all like to play the beautiful game. As we see this chance again from Morgan, it might have crept in, but the keeper made sure. Good run from Garrett. Morgan, well, he got there in time, but he hadn't a lot of time to try and beat that man there.
Yeah, the goalkeeper, he used his frame well, and it was a good save.
Oh, that's good. That's very good. Not good enough, though, from Braniff. Man who was player of the semi-finals, trying to make his mark.
You know, again, I'm looking at Richard Clark. I'd like to see more on from Richard. That was a ball there. Braniff won quite easily. But Clark should have had his foot in. Clark should have had more determination. The rumour mill would be saying that Richard's going to Portadown this season. Next season. I hope that's not on his mind. It wouldn't be on his mind this moment in time. He's a better player than he's shown at this moment in time.
Feeney. Morgan. Oh, it's a lovely ball in. It's a very good ball in. But it's gone behind. Keegan was in there trying to force it into that Portadown net. And look who's at the back of all this. Two very experienced players, Morgan and Lee Feeney, just didn't fall for Keegan. And I think at the far post it might have been Taggart who did a good covering job.
Yes, he did actually, but Kevin just left it for that split second too long, Jackie, and his angles were all wrong, unfortunately for him. But Newry are now coming into the game. They've had a couple of chances in the last few minutes, and that's bound to give them heart.
I'm trying to see Ronnie McFall on the other side. He's looking quiet. I'm sure he'll have something to say about the pressure in the last few minutes coming from the opposition. There he is, Kieran Harding, looking at his watch. Having another bit of chewing gum. Calm the nerves, Ronald. Newry try to get forward again. Friars with the free kick. Hunter with the clearance. Boyle. How's that for a bit of skill? Braniff into space, but gives it away. Keegan picks it up for Newry. Yeah, Garrett was being held. A little bit of a mix-up there between two Portadown players. There's McCluskey and Convery, and then Convery, I think, gave away the free kick.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. The last thing Big John Convery would like is a little man getting in around him, and he certainly made sure that he wasn't going anywhere.
17 minutes left of this final. Richard Clark, 13 goals for the season. He lets it go. Boyle with the clearance. He's been in quite a shift today, Wes Boyle, hasn't he?
Yes, he's probably been one of the better players on the park, in my opinion, up to now, Jackie. Yeah, he's done very well.
Black. Hunter. Lee Feeney. This is where he likes to get it. Run at people. Gives it outside. That's not a bad ball in. Just too high for Morgan. He was never getting to it.
No, he wasn't, Jackie. You need a ball like that to be falling into the path of Chris for him to run into. Unfortunately, Keegan just overhit the cross a little bit.
I think O'Hara does well here. He's making sure Morgan doesn't get there.
He did exactly what you wanted the fullback to do in that position.
That's young Taggart going off. And 14 coming on, former Linfield player. Tim Mouncey. He won the Irish Cup with Linfield in 2006, the 2-1 victory over Glentoran. Big Tim. He hasn't been a regular in the starting lineup with Portadown this season.
I think Tim's picked up a fair amount of injuries since he's come to Shamrock Park, actually, Jackie.
Yeah, he's been unlucky that way.
He has been very unlucky. He's come in wide right. I just noticed Wes Boyle has gone over to the other side. Wes is quite versatile. Two good feet, and there he is on the
lovely
ball.
Lovely ball from Boyle. McCutcheon is into the gap. Now, O'Hara will hit it with the left foot, and he hits it very, very badly. Keith O'Hara, one league goal this season back in November. With finishing like that.
Say no more.
Say no more. Not your best effort, Keith. Made sure of the clearance, though. In front of the pack stand here. We have some 2,000 Portadown fans here today, to their credit. About 900 or so from Newry City. So Donegan.
Jackie, it's great to see so many fans up from Newry today and supporting their team, and hopefully they can get into the habit, because the
I was going to say, it'd be nice to see them every Saturday, wouldn't it?
It certainly would. I mean, facility-wise at Newry, they've worked so hard to get a good team out in the park and then to build their stadium. It's absolutely terrific at the moment, and hope a lot of these young children and get into the habit and start torching their parents to bring them down to the showgrounds on a more regular basis.
Coleman came out soaring there like a basketball player, took it well. Now Portadown have it. He lines up the shot. Convery. I've seen him hit better efforts. He didn't trouble Andy Coleman.
It was interesting. Chris Coleman came for the cross, great catch, but then his arm was caught, and that could have been a very costly incident.
Good spot, Marty. Keegan clipped it in, comes to nothing. Ferguson. Colin Feeney. Again, the ball forward is not good.
Ronnie McFall, 13 minutes and whatever has to be added on, away from winning his 30th trophy as a manager in his 29-year career. But Newry may want to change that. They are trying everything to alter the scoreline and the result. They still have it. Ferguson blocked. Lee Feeney leaves it. In goes the shot. It was Ross Black, but that man there got down very quickly.
Yeah, that was a good strike from Ross Black. Actually got plenty on it. Yeah, you know, credit the lad. I mean, I was saying early days I thought he wasn't going to last the pace too long, but he's been fine and he hasn't been struggling at all.
McCutcheon, giving it away. Richard Clark was impeded. They've taken it quickly. Feeney. That looked like a free kick as well. He's got it. Emmett Friars eventually takes it. Now, Ferguson. Morgan shoes the ball and turns so well. Keegan just doesn't drop to a blue shirt. Well, Braniff. Reminds me of a fellow who strained a hamstring, Ronnie.
Yes, I think Kenneth's a carry now for some 10 minutes or so now. Jackie's been limping in the blood from Richard Leckie, number 12, yeah, Richard Leckie.
Richard Leckie got the winner in the semi-final.
Richard came in from Derby at the start of the season and he's taken his time to settle at the level he's at now. But he's certainly come off the bench and scored some valuable goals along the way, and he's a lad with a good reputation.
Yeah, he's got 10 goals this season, Richard Leckie. Two of those in this cup competition. Vital one, the winner in extra time against Lisburn Distillery to get them to this showpiece final. No, that's good. Break on here for Mouncey. This is good, it's very good, it's 2-0, it should have been. Well, 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 he can't believe it. I can't believe it, and I'm quite sure Ronnie McFall will not believe it. Good build-up, Leckie involved almost immediately. Should have buried it, Marty.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that, Jack. An unbelievable miss from a striker in that area, and he'll have a few nightmares about that one. But he'll be a happy man if the score finishes as it is at this moment in time, because he'll have scored the winner.
Flag is up. That's lucky. He's a tall boy. There's the Port Down substitute. Football, what a game, eh? McCutcheon's going to be the hero, it seems. And he's just missed a sitter. Lee Feeney. Newry have not given up the ghost, not by a long chalk. That goes too hard and too far for everyone.
Yeah, as you say, Jackie, that would have been game, set and match for Portadown. If Gary had finished that one, there was absolutely no way back for Newry City. They're coming into the game more, as I say, when if they can get Keegan into the game more often. I mean, he's got more of the ball, he's got more good crosses into the box, and been causing the problems.
Just looking at that replay again, there's your talking, Marty. The crowd behind the goal, we saw it clearly. They just couldn't believe that McCutcheon had sliced it wide. Ross Black has gone off. Eventually, who else is going off? It's Lee Feeney, sadly for Newry. So Tony Anderson is one of the men coming on.
Tony.
No, that's...
Yeah, Darren King has just come in and replaced, a straight replacement for Darren King at left back, and
Darren King.
Tony Anderson, striker, will play up front along with Gard and Morgan.
Darren King, yeah, 23-year-old, the man they call the engine, can get about a bit.
What he does have to also, Jackie, is a long throw. He can throw a long ball into the box, which they might be hoping to utilise, and as I say, Anderson's going to play a higher line than Lee Feeney played.
Coleman, Newry,
desperate to get that equaliser to get back into this cup final. They know that time is running away from them. Keegan will pick up. Donegan, give it inside. Gave it inside. Cullen Feeney. Cool, clever. Donegan. Mouncey. O'Hara launches it long. Too long. Well, always anxious moments as we saw confirmation there of the changes for Newry City. Always tense times for managers, and you will know what I'm talking about, Marty, better than I do.
Yeah, I'm sure Ron will be starting to look at the watch, and Jerry, you know, Jerry on the other hand will be looking for more time and hoping that the referee's assistant, the fourth official, will get the signal to play 4 or 5 minutes extra, but I can't see where they're going to be coming from, probably 2 to 3 minutes as usual.
Yeah.
And
he has a resigned look in his face there, Jerry, but he always keeps cool on the line. And I think that's a good thing for managers.
Yes, he learned that from his from one of his ex-managers, Jack Egan, assure you. Stay calm.
It can't have been you.
Don't get too excited.
Just hearing an announcement from a BBC colleague, Alan Simpson, of radio fame. As that ball gets through to Mouncey, he could be in for some fame of his own. Tim Mouncey, he'll square it. Where's Boyle? It's blocked. That's great defending. Last-ditch defending. I think it was Cullen Feeney who got in the way. That would have been game, set and match.
And no doubt about that, Jagan. And if Wes Boyle, a great lay back here from Tim Mouncey. Unfortunately for Wes Boyle, who thoroughly deserved a goal for his display this afternoon, the Newry defenders got in and defended very well and deserved to break the cup.
Indeed they did. I was trying to make a point and I've forgotten what it was.
You're slagging me at this time of the day, Jackie. You should be having your afternoon nap around now, should you?
Perhaps my producer, if he's still awake, will tell me. Coming up to 5 minutes left at Mournview Park. I promised you goals. I was wrong. We've got one goal. We should have had more, though. Will we have late drama? Morgan. He sliced it. He's got through the game well, though, in terms of fitness, after not really training all week, Chris Morgan.
Yes, he has. Chris has given a very honest effort this afternoon. He put himself about and he's worked very hard.
Wiskelly getting away from the referee. Come on, hurry up. Let's not be wasting any time. King. O'Hara's header. Whistler's gone. Morgan's header. Forward by Clark. Who Cameron collected was Emmett Friars. This is good, and then it isn't so good. Well, that looks like Johnny Topley, who's coming on. And going off, number six, David McCulloch. Just 2.5 minutes and whatever's to be added. We're getting near having a few little technical problems with the sound. I'm having problems hearing my producer, but Marty, I believe we're getting close to man of the match time.
Yes, indeed.
You just leave it. You just leave it a minute if you want to. Yes, but give me a couple of contenders.
Yeah, well, obviously, you know, you look at your goal scorer today, Gary McCutcheon. He's been excellent. He's led the line very well, and I also feel that Kevin Braniff had a big shift this afternoon. John Convery at the back hasn't let anything past him. He was done exactly what you would expect him to do. On the Newry side, they've worked very hard as a team, as a unit, and I would be looking at Emmett Friars. He's been outstanding in the central defensive position. Got to give Chris Morgan a lot of credit up front. Chris has worked his socks off and was so unlucky not to score in the first half and also the second half.
And who's... Oh, right, just hold it for a moment. McCutcheon comes wide. Tim Mouncey, tall man, but a very good ball player. As I say that, he loses out. But he helped get it back. Garrett, it's running away from him, and one of the men you mentioned in the running for man of the match, John Convery, takes it away from him. So Marty, who's your top man?
Well, Jackie, as I said, I've named the players there, have done very well, as of all the players who credit the Irish League football, but I think the outstanding player, in my opinion today, has been Wes Boyle. I think he's been outstanding. He's been on the end of everything. He was responsible for the Portadown goal, but I think his overall play has been top drawer.
Yeah, he's been up front, he's been back defending, and I wouldn't have any argument with you there, Marty. So Wes Boyle is the man of the match of this Cooperative Insurance Cup final. So we're into time added on. I haven't seen the board go up. At this point, I don't know how long has been added on. McCutcheon, will they go for number two? They could have a chance here. Leckie is in the middle. Here's Boyle, our man of the match. And he didn't do so well on that occasion. But
no, he actually should have done a lot better, Jackie. Leckie was at the back post just awaiting an early delivery. Wes unfortunately decided to take an extra touch on it and it was closed down. Should have done better.
They're keeping it in the corner. It was offside as it was played back to McCutcheon. Side again, Portadown will not worry. There's the man who's got the only goal, and he'll be the goal scoring hero of this cup win, the 30th of manager Ronnie McFall's long career. Six trophies. Sorry, as that ball goes in there, Sorry, Marty. Six trophies with Glen Torren. This will be his 24th with Portadown, including four league titles and three Irish Cups. He joined in December 86, but has he won this one? Well, well, well. Convery so angry. 3 minutes and going by my clock and the one on your screen, we're into the dying embers. Clark, are we to have drama right at the end? Convery with the header, O'Hara with the second header.
Yeah, and Urie are just throwing the kitchen sink now in the last ditch effort to try and get something from the game.
It's overhead, it's a looping ball, the keeper had to stretch. Almost drama, but for that man there. King, they've got to get forward, it's too late, it's all over. Portadown have won, celebrations on the bench. There's the manager. December 86, he's into his 23rd year as the boss at Shamrock Park. Just refusing my radio colleagues a little interview there. There's the man who'd be remembered for scoring the goal after half an hour. We had so many chances. Newry will rue their luck on the day. They went so close. They hit the woodwork a couple of times. Real thunderbolt, particularly from Chris Morgan. Marty, sum it up.
Well, I think outside of the Chris Morgan effort, you know, Portadown had more of the chances throughout the game. They did enough when they scored the early goal. They put their foot on it. They killed the game off. And as I say, Newry didn't give up easily, but they certainly weren't creative enough, and they weren't positive enough, in my opinion. They didn't create enough, and the game just ground out to a 1-0 win. And I think Portadown deserved it overall.
So Portadown, Ronnie back amongst the silverware. He'll enjoy this achievement. They've beaten Cliftonville, they've beaten Linfield, they've beaten Glen Torren on the way, and now they've beaten another Premier League side, Newry, in the final. First trophy for 4 years, but promotion is the main objective. The fans know that, but hey, they'll enjoy this moment. Final score in this Cooperative Insurance Cup final. They're celebrating. They've won it. Portadown 1, Newry City 0.
Thank you very much indeed, Jackie. David Jeffrey and Stephen Baxter are here with me in the studio watching the celebrations. David, Portadown deserved winners this afternoon?
I think so, Stephen. First 10 minutes of the second half was a little bit nondescript. Then it livened up. Newry had a couple of chances, and you thought really they needed to take their opportunities when they were on top. They didn't do so. Portadown got a grip again, and really, to be honest, they could have scored a second and possibly a third goal. So very deserved winners.
A cracking cup final, Stephen, wasn't it?
Oh yeah, yeah, it was good stuff today. You know, there's been many chances at both ends of the park. You know, Newry have hit the woodwork twice, but saying all of that, there, Portadown have missed two gilt-edged opportunities as well to really put the icing on the cake. But yeah, tremendous final. Good for the fans. Good for television. Good for everybody. So. Big success.
Portadown, of course, came here with a point to prove. They're playing in the Championship, as we've talked about during the programme, and they'll feel a little bit of vindication here today, won't they?
I have no doubt about that, Stephen. You know, as I say, they are deserved champions. You know, Cliftonville, ourselves, and Glen Torren, you know, and then to come here and to play the way they did today was absolutely superb. I'm delighted from the people of Portadown. They're a very, very warm contingent. There's Big Emmett Friars, who's bitterly disappointed. There's a man who I'm delighted for, Andrew Hunter. Served us fantastically well, was scourged by injuries, and I thought he was a colossus today. Certainly John Convery was good, but I'm really pleased for Andrew.
OK, let's hear from the winning goal scorer, Gary McCutcheon.
Thank you very much, Stephen. Gary, just tell me how it feels.
Obviously, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Didn't play well on the day, but cup final's all about winning, and fortunate enough, we got the win.
The goal, you took it so well. I mean, just quick turn, bottom corner, and that ultimately proved the difference.
Yeah, it sat up lovely for me, so it did. I mean, I just put everything I had into it, and it went across the goalie, and fortunately for me, it went in.
We're watching it now. How sweet was it? Because there was an opportunity fell about 10 minutes ago, which I'm sure you would have had nightmares about, had Newry equalised.
Well, that's right. I mean, we had a few near the end there, me, Boiler, and a couple of other boys, but we got there in the end, and that's all that matters.
Let's bring in the man who was named man of the match. Wes, I think you were actually the man who cushioned the header down for his finish. You will claim a big part in it.
Yeah, that's right. And it cleared the ball the edge of the box and just seen Cutsey at the corner of my eye and just thought I headed down to him, and it was a great finish, man.
And man of the match performance from you, that will mean something given, I suppose, that not so many years ago there was a career in the prospect at Leeds and then injury cut it short and you're now back to the hometown.
Yeah, that's right. Enjoying my time here at Port Down. Thought it was apparently the good man of the match, obviously delighted with that. There's a lot of friends and family in the crowd and just really happy for all the lads and all the supporters.
Big day for you, big day for the family, big day for the community.
That's right, yeah. I mean, I've loads of friends, as I said, loads of friends and families in the crowd, so really had to make sure we put on a performance, and I think we did that.
What about the big man on your left? He wasn't too bad, the man between the posts.
Oh, yeah, Dave has been brilliant all season. I'd say he's one of the best keeper in the league. Pulled off some great saves, thought he had a great game.
David, you were a busy man.
Busier than I'd like to be. Probably through some of my own mistakes as well, but I haven't played for a while, so that's for Big Neil as well. You know, he's played all the main games against Linfield and Glentoran, so it was an honour to play here today, but it was a great day, you know.
I was watching the game with Tommy Wright, the former international keeper. He thought that you had an outstanding game, so that's high praise indeed.
Well, Big Tommy, I know Big Tommy well, so when he says that sort of thing, and you take it into your head, and that drives you on, you know.
Presumably the confidence as well up from that early double save, early doors.
Should have done better with it the first time. It sort of caught me off guard, I didn't know what way to go with it, but it was offside anyway. I thought the one from Morgan's shot was probably a better save.
The skipper's just on our left here, Mr. Convery. In you come, Captain. Let me congratulate you. Piece of silverware, and I take it matters a whole lot to you.
Oh, it's fantastic. You know, I mean, start of the season there, we didn't know what was happening with the club. Everybody's rallied together, and you know, to be in with a shout for promotion first time round, and lifting the cooperative, you know, it's fantastic for the club supporters.
Cliftonville, Linfield, Glentoran, Newry, all Premier League sides, and all, I presume, big scalps supported them, and you had a point to prove.
Yeah, I mean, we had a point to prove, but you know, in my opinion, you know, man for man, we're as good as any of them teams, you know. What matters off the pitch, that's why we're in the league below, but I mean, you know, the players have got together and we've shown that we can play against the likes of Linfield and Glentoran.
Quick word on Newry, John. Do you feel for them today? Because they did really make a game off at hitting the woodwork a couple of times and coming close.
Yeah, they did. I mean, we're holding on there. It's back to the wall at the end. First half, it was a strong wind blowing. We thought come out the second half, we had it in our backs. But, I mean, all credit to Newry. They threw everything at us, you know.
There's a presentation to be made soon. You go off and get your hands on the cup. I'll bring in Ronnie McFall if you just bear with us. Ronnie, congratulations. Jackie was doing all the facts and figures. Year 29 in management and silverware, I think, the 30th trophy. Not bad. You'll be pleased with it.
Well, I thought, obviously, delighted for everyone with the club, especially the players, for what we've been through this season. They've been magnificent all season. I thought the game was a bit scrappy at times. Pitch wasn't the best. They hit the woodwork twice, but we missed basically virtually open goals. And it goes right, Sam. We're absolutely delighted of won the CAS, and that gets us into Setanta.
Yeah, Gary McCutcheon bags the winner for you and did take it very well, but presumably had Newry managed an equaliser, you would have been having a word with him because the goal was gaping when it seemed that the ball bubbled for what was looked like a certain 2-0.
Yeah, well, the pitch is very poor, you know, so it was, but as I said, McCutcheon's a natural predator and he did fully deserved the goal. He's been doing that for us ever from he came.
I was just saying to your captain, all Premier League opposition you've beaten in it, and it's an accident, of course, of administration that you're not in Premier League, Ronnie. Presumably you feel that you deserve to be back there.
Well, without a doubt. I mean, football should be decided on the pitch, not in the offices. And it says three new fault of the players that were in this situation, but we've got to make sure that we get out of it.
Wes Boyle, just be presented with the man of the match by Nigel Worthington. He had a great game for you.
Well, he's talented. I mean, he was 15, we sold him to Leeds United, and he picked up a bad injury, and he came back to us again, and he's standing tall.
Is the 30th trophy as sweet as the first?
Oh, without a doubt.
Okay, Ronnie, we wish you well. Thank you very much. Back to the boys.
Ronnie McFall, a happy man this evening. 30 trophies is an incredible record, isn't it?
Incredible record, Stephen, when you think the vast majority of them have been won with Portadown. I've got to take issue with the big fella. I didn't think it was a scrappy game. I thought the players coped very well with the pitch and the wind, the conditions all around. I thought it was a great game of football, but as a manager, you tend to be very subjective. But well done, big Ronnie. He's an absolute character, fantastic manager, and as I say, when you look at his record, what he's done down the years, superb, and a tremendous loyal servant to Portadown.
Yeah, 24 trophies with Portadown. After seeing what they offered us this afternoon, does it make everyone realise perhaps what the Irish Premiership is missing this year without them?
Well, I just said to David halfway through the second half, because we're at the bottom end of the ground here, and said, look at the crowd here behind this goal. And we need teams like Portadown in Irish League football. They bring the big support, big occasions. And, you know, it'll be great if we see them win the championship and come back straight back into the league again.
But credit to Newry as well today, David. They really did help make it a cracking cup final.
Other than the crossbar, they could have had, you know, at least a couple of goals. David Maskelly made, as I say, two great saves. They really contributed to a great day. They had their moments. But sometimes if your name is on it, Stephen, then no matter what you do, it doesn't go for you. And I think Portadown, what they've achieved, how they've progressed. There's a lovely shot there with Big Emmett Friars. He's a great lad, so he is. But I think Portadown, Stephen, really do deserve it overall for what they've done.
Okay, Portadown's name are on the cup. Newry picking up their losers' medals this afternoon. We hand back to Jackie for the trophy presentation.
Thank you, gentlemen. I would take issue with Ronnie as well. He's hard to please. I agree with David. It wasn't scrappy. It was always interesting. Lots of chances. Hugh Wade, Coleraine chairman, vice chairman of the IFA Premiership. There's Lee Feeney going through. Substitutes coming through. And, well, that face sums it up. Jerry Flynn. But he'll be back. Second year in management. He's got to a cup final. And he'll know it could have been so different, but he walks away with nothing, although they do get £11,000 as a beaten finalist. But that will not mean anything to that man at this moment. £15,000 goes to the winners, but it's all about the trophy. They'll hand out the medals first. Tim Mouncey came on as a substitute, man who's won silverware at Linfield going forward. This is Dick Parkhouse, the sponsor from the sponsors, Cooperative Insurance. There's Andy Hunter. More medals for him. Kevin Braniff didn't get on the score sheet today, but worked so hard. David McCulloch. Number 15 there, another substitute. Johnny Topley didn't get on. Lecky, the manager's nephew, Ross Redmond. There's the man of the match, Wes Boyle. And he must have been a contender as well, the keeper, Maskelly. Smiles all round. And there's finally the man whose goal captured the trophy as the remaining medals are handed out. And here he is, his expression. Wouldn't let you know that he's won it, but he has trophy number 30 in the bag. And I'm sure, as a championship side, nothing to do with their playing. It was all down to poor administration. This will be a very sweet moment for Ronnie McFall. Alan Simpson, he of the hair and glasses. John Convery on the right. The big man, he's lifted silverware before, part of the Irish Cup winning side 4 years ago. They're back in business with regards picking up cups. Great run in this tournament for them. Always a nice moment that, Marty, as a player or a manager.
Yesterday, you know, that's why we're all in the game, Jackie, to try and win trophies. And a very proud moment for John Convery, and I'm sure for Ronnie McFall. I mean, his 30th winner's medal today, and it's an absolutely fantastic achievement for one of the provincial clubs, and all credit to him. I'd also like to congratulate the Portadown fans, if I may, in their applauding of the Newry players as they came through. I thought it was very nice in today's football. Sometimes that doesn't happen, but that was very nice gesture.
Yeah, as they celebrate and drink the champagne, Newry have to trudge off. That is always a very disappointing moment. Away to the right, they'll maybe have a little bit more champagne this evening, but the champagne and the beer will be a bit flat in Newry City. There they are. Always a disappointment. They don't remember the losers, they say, in cup finals. They just remember the winners. Portadown did that today. They picked up that trophy. And I'm sure, with a fair wind, we might see them back in the Premier League next season. Back to you, Stephen. We've enjoyed it. I hope you have in the studio.
Absolutely, Jackie. Thank you very much indeed. So one cup for Portadown. They're still in the Irish Cup as well, of course. You'll be taking an interest in that one, Stephen. You've got them next week.
Yeah, it's going to be a very difficult tie for us. We're down at their place, and Ronnie, as I say, will be buoyed by this performance today.
Oh, hi, absolutely.
And, yeah, so, you know, they're going to want to come and show again what they can do at this highest level. But, you know, we've had a good season. We're not frightened of going there. We're looking forward to the game. It'll be a big cup day out, so for everybody. Same for all the teams in the quarterfinals. You've got to play your football and see if you can get the result.
But Portadown won't want to take their eye off their main goal this season, David, of course, which is to win the championship and get that promotion.
Absolutely, Stephen, I agree with you. But there's, have you ever seen a man whose emotions with his body language are so incongruent? He's going to write a new book, Mr. Happy from Portadown.
Oh, inside he's happy.
Oh,
today.
I know he is. No, they've done fantastically well. I can tell you now, Ronnie McFall would swap everything. Today and what they've done in other competitions just to get promotion. They went back in the big time and that's where they should be. Well done, Ronnie. Well done, Portadown. And also well done, Yuri. They were very respectful, very, very gracious at the end, standing to allow Portadown to get their celebrations through. But the day belongs to the big man. Day belongs to Portadown. Absolutely fantastic.
Let's just finish up by having a look at that winning cup winner this afternoon by Gary McCutcheon. It finished 1-0 here at Mournview Park this afternoon. Portadown are the Cooperative Insurance Cup winners for 2009. Now, just before we go, time to tell you about David Jeffrey and Stephen Baxter. Thank you very much indeed for your company. Don't forget, Ireland-England is coming up in the Six Nations Rugby very shortly at 5:15 on BBC One. But for now, we'll rejoin our network colleagues here on BBC Two for Final Score. Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through.